Did you ever see the TV series Black White? There was one season of it. I think it was on FX. You can get the DVD on Amazon. Watch that if you get a chance.
In a speech to the National Press Club in Washington,
So what they
Jindal says
did,
he wants to say what everybody's
kind
thinking
of
about
what you're
Donald
talking
Trump.
about,
it's
you
been
know,
a
like
lot
the
of fun.
confirmation bias sort of thing.
But here's the problem.
They took a black family and a
Donald
white
Trump
family
is not a serious
and then
candidate.
Lived together.
He's a
That
narcissist.
makeup artist.
He's an egomaniac.
At
The only thing he believes in is himself.
On Wall Street today, the Dow Jones Industrial Average up by 77 points, 16,330. The Nasdaq rose 40. The S&P advanced 10. Crude oil up $1.77 to $45.92 a barrel. More on these stories at townhall.com.
Black get put in white makeup, and they
Vault flooring season is on, and the Lumber Liquidators flooring experts can help you find the best deals for the hottest looks in flooring. Right now, we've got incredible deals on easy-to-install, laminate engineered floors, and more, like our thickest, beautiful acacia laminate for only 99 cents. Or get 10% off Schon engineered pre-finished hardwood floors, plus Morningstar natural strand bamboo for only $2.69. Or get gorgeous, solid, hand-scraped mahogany hardwood at 27% off, with more amazing deals in your store, and 12-month special financing. Sales going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
The average family wastes numerous gallons of water a day waiting for it to heat up.
There's got to be a better way.
And that's not just wasted water, that's wasted time and money down the drain. Thanks to the smart recirculation technology of Renai's new Ultra Series tankless water heaters, faster hot water and big savings on water and gas are now just a turn of the knob away.
I knew there was a better way.
Faster hot water and the power to live better are here, only for Renai tankless water heaters. To learn more, visit us at renai.us. That's RINNAI.US.
10 vehicles have been struck by either bullets or projectiles along Phoenix, Arizona freeways, mostly along Interstate 10 west of the city. Arizona Department of Public Safety spokesman Bart Graves describes what affected motorists are telling authorities about these incidents.
We're getting a lot of reports of windows suddenly being smashed or caving in. They're not sure what occurred. Some say they heard a loud bang.
A list released by the Department of Public Safety indicates the 10 vehicles struck through Wednesday included three pickups, three passenger cars, two box trucks, an SUV, and a commercial tour bus with no passengers aboard. Five family members, including three children, were found dead in their lakeside home in the upscale western Minneapolis suburb of Lake Minnetonka. Police say it appears to be a case of murder-suicide. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters.
Such as?
The highest-ranking woman in American politics says she is not concerned over Hillary Clinton's declining poll numbers.
I have confidence in the integrity of Hillary Clinton.
House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi suggesting a number of factors could be to blame for Clinton's declining poll numbers.
I don't stipulate to the fact that it's about the emails. Who knows what it could be about? It could be about another candidate moving forward.
Pelosi says frontrunners rarely maintain their initial popularity.
That's Capitol Hill correspondent Wally Hines reporting. Baltimore's mayor says a judge's decision today to try six police officers in Baltimore rather than move the trials elsewhere will help the city heal. The officers are facing charges in the death of Freddie Gray, who died a week after he was critically injured in police custody. The death sparked unrest on Baltimore's streets. Defense lawyers had argued that the officers wouldn't be able to get a fair trial in Baltimore. More on these stories at townhall.com.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral. Don't pick on the IRS alone. I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
So I found out the other day that at guns80.com, a lot of people don't get the Ghost AR-15 rifle kits because they're afraid that they won't be able to do the machining work required to drill out and make ready the lower. Well, listen, guys, gals, I am not that good of a machinist, I promise you. But I was able to take a drill press with an XY table and knock this out in about 45 minutes, and in all honesty, mine looks really good. Go get yours. Don't be afraid. It's easy. Guns80.com. Go to guns80.com now.
Talk Live.
Talk Live. It's Mark with you.
Daryl.
And Johnson.
This is the show where you can call in and talk about whatever you want to talk about, but we bring things to the table. And I got to say, there's an issue that I've kind of been uncomfortable about for some time. My opinions changed over the years, and I just don't...
We all know what it is.
What's that?
The issue that you're uncomfortable about. It's okay.
Yeah, thanks.
Showering now, with Ian?
That, of the many things that have happened, that is not one of them.
Because you're uncomfortable about it, but you're like coming around.
No. What we're talking about here is, by the way, Ian is off this evening. It's his night off on Thursday. So, yeah, the issue is anthropogenic global climate change. Now, I tend to believe scientists when scientists say things. Because, you know, when you find yourself an expert, you should believe the expert. That's the best bet. However, I do think that there's just been these article after article over time that kind of shows this thing's messed up, that thing's messed up. And it makes it difficult for me to believe that anthropogenic global climate change is what's happening. So, Daryl, you brought in something. What's your source?
So this comes from Tech Insider. The website is techinsider.io. And
IO is the new hip dot after thing. I don't know.
It stands for like in out. You put things in a computer and then you get things out of the computer. So that's what the IO technically stands for.
Usually it stands out for a nation, but okay. Go ahead.
So the article says about 97% of scientists agree that not only is climate change real, but also that human activity, like driving a fossil fuel burning car, is making it worse. That agreement stems from nearly 4,000 studies that suggest humans are culpable, compared to about 80 studies where they say that humans have nothing whatsoever to do with the problem.
Those, so what are the numbers again?
Yeah. 4,000
to 80. 4,000 to 80. So 4,000 studies say humans are the cause of global climate change.
Yes.
And, you know, yes, well, let's get this out of the way. It used to be called global warming. And
before that, it was global cooling. Now, when I was in middle school, global cooling was going to kill us all.
Right. That was a thing, but that had to do with, like, the lining up of the planets. It was far less science-y and a lot more voodoo-y.
But no, it was, there's a giant hole in the ozone layer causing global cooling, and if something trees, then we're going to an ice age.
Well, I'll tell you.
My favorite science is phrenology.
Phrenology is the study of bumps on people's heads.
Have you ever felt the dents in my head?
I don't care about the bumps in your head. The issue here is that if you have a problem with what happened with the ozone layer, you need to acknowledge that governments passing bans on chlorofluorocarbons had a positive effect in that area. And that's not something that libertarians like to do.
So right.
Go ahead. 8,000, it's 4,000 studies to 80.
4,000 to
80. How do you judge what was a positive effect, though?
Well, we don't have, nobody's talking, nobody's talking about the ozone layer any longer. Hold on just one second. And before we give out a bunch of misinformation here, .io stands for the British Indian Ocean Territory.
You know what? Yes, that's the technical thing, but everybody says like in out because internet something, okay. Computer.
You just like talking about things that go in and out, don't you?
No.
All right.
No. So the numbers of studies at 4,000 to 80 should leave us pretty confident. The author writes that humans are indeed fueling climate change. However, you could argue that there's a really small chance that those 2% of studies actually have it right. So, a team of 7 climate scientists and meteorologists decided to give climate contrarians the benefit of the doubt.
Another thing that sort of held me up on my road to believing in anthropogenic global climate change, excuse me, that's such a long name.
Yes.
Is that for a while there, Michael Crichton, whose books I've read, I think all of them, was a denier. And there was like a group of North American meteorologists who are like, nah, this is bullcrap. And so you've got these, you know, meteorologists working with weather all the time. They're saying, no, that's not the case. Now, I don't know if that information has changed, but over time I've been sort of pounded with this info. So I tend to, I've sort of adopted it. But I just, since you mentioned meteorologists, I wanted to mention that there was a time when meteorologists denied that global climate change was occurring.
Right, and there probably still are some meteorologists that will deny that humans are the sole reason for climate change. So the seven climate scientists and meteorologists picked half of the more popular studies that say humans are not the cause. The hallmark of a good scientific paper is that it's reproducible, meaning another scientist can do the same experiment and get the same or similar results. What happened? Beyond being unable to replicate most of the results, the team discovered major flaws in the papers.
Oh, so you're saying that I misunderstood you early on when we were talking about this. What you're saying is that it's the climate change deniers who have the bullcrap studies.
That's what this article is saying.
Okay,
yes.
Go ahead.
Beyond being unable to replicate most of the results, the team discovered major flaws in the papers. In fact, many papers left out essential data and some even ignored basic physics. Dana Nusitelli, one of the scientists who helped analyze the climate denier paper for the journal Theoretical and Applied Climatology, summed up what this team found in a blog post for The Guardian. Below are the three biggest, most common problems that the team found with the small minority of the studies that dispute human involvement in climate change. And in real big, giant, bold letters, it says, climate change deniers cherry-pick the data. Nusitelli and his colleagues examined 38 widely referenced papers that dispute human involvement in climate change.
Well, this is cherry picking it's a pretty common human thing to do.
Yes.
But for instance, if you see it's cold out and you say to yourself, and you say to the guy at the in line for coffee at the coffee shop, you say, it's climate change. Right. It's global warming. Right. Like that's cherry picking to some extent. It's just because it's cold for you today doesn't mean that the climate hasn't increased by 1.2 degrees Fahrenheit or whatever it is that the claim is that it's increased by. I don't know the answer to that. I think, by the way, in order to sort of switch gears for a second, those that claim that climate change is true and then show pictures of polar bears, trapped on icebergs or something like that, you know, suggesting that we're going to wipe out this and wipe out that, do a real disservice to the cause, as it were.
Or the people that talk about mass relocations from flooding. Oh, my God, the water level's going to rise. These cities are going to be underwater. Yeah, the water level's going to rise over the course of 200 years. Yes, there will be displacements of people. Do you think you're going to have time to move? I don't know. Can you pack your stuff in 200 years? I don't know. I don't know where I'm going to get the boxes in that amount of time. Oh, no.
I know there's a lot of rich people in Sarasota, Florida who are going to own some pieces of the Gulf of Mexico if they're not careful.
Well, that's definitely.
They're still going to be alive in 200 years?
They may. I've got my brain preserved through Alcor. Just go to ALCOR.org. Tell them Mark Edge sent you. If you mention my name, I get 6 months worth of my subscription for free.
Actually, if the sea level rises according to the predictions, Florida will not exist.
Completely gone?
Yeah, completely gone.
Oh, well, I've spent
that's
a lot of,
probably
spent
a good
lot of time
thing.
In Florida.
The article here continues. It says the team learned that these papers often ignored critical background information or left out big sets of climate data. In one example, the authors of a 2011 paper tried to show the lunar and solar cycle are responsible for climate change, but they ignored 6,000 years worth of data that did not jive with their idea.
6,000 years worth of data?
Wow, those scientists sure have been around for a long time.
Yeah, I'm a little skeptical of that claim, but whatever.
Is this article from Slate?
No.
Tech Insider.
Okay.
Your thoughts on global climate change, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live or LRN.FM on Skype.
The following is an important free offer for smokers only.
The makers of O2 Pure, the world's most advanced e-cigarette, have just authorized the release of free starter kits to all smokers who call in the next 10 minutes. Valued at $99, these starter kits are available for free, but only while supplies last. To guarantee your free kit, call in the next 10 minutes, 1-800-717-9859. The revolutionary O2 Pure design creates only water vapor. There is no foul-smelling smoke and no nasty tar. This allows individuals to enjoy the nicotine they love whenever and wherever they are. The financial advantages over cigarettes are considerable as well. It is estimated that the average smoker can save hundreds of dollars a month with O2 Pure. Again, free starter kits are now available to any smoker who calls in the next 10 minutes. This is a radio-only offer not available in stores, so call now for your free kit. 1-800-717-9859. 1-800-717-9859. 1-800-717-9859.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth slide into a recession or, at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common-sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Healthy, organic, fresh fish, robust, mouth-watering vegetables, all from your home. It's called aquaponics. This brilliant, self-sustaining protein and veggie system is perfect for year-round growing. Know exactly where your food is coming from. AquaponicsSource.com is the one-stop shop for all your needs. Fish, fish food, plumbing, full systems, classes, and more. Learn to build your own system. Go to AquaponicsSource.com for a free guide to aquaponics. That's AquaponicsSource.com.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Free Talk Live. 855-450-3733. Looks like they're, well, looks like some scientists have gone through the studies that show that global climate change doesn't exist and found that those studies are bullcrap. Your thoughts, 855-450-3733. It's Mark with you.
Daryl.
And Johnson.
Now, I am headed off to Las Vegas on October the 29th and 30th. I'll be out there doing the show live from the Bitcoin Investor Conference. I'll be there with Trace Mayer, Dr. Stephanie Murphy, former co-host here, and lots of other speakers. Check them out at the website. It's bitcoininvestor.com. They've still got early bird tickets. They're available to you. It's bitcoininvestor.com. It's happening at the beautiful D Hotel in downtown Las Vegas, which I believe to be the only... Well, anyway, they are taking Bitcoins. I shouldn't make a claim that I'm not entirely certain of, but I have heard the announcement, and it seemed like big news that they're taking Bitcoins, so it gets me the impression that no other casinos are doing that. So it's going to be a lot of fun, and it's you don't want to miss it. So
check are they taking it for the hotel or for the gambling?
I think they take it for everything.
Interesting.
Yeah. Bitcoininvestor.com. Come out and join me. It's going to be a lot of fun. So let's go to the phones. Eric, calling in from Georgia. Eric, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
I wanted to talk about immigration.
Go right ahead. And
mainly, yeah, say that, well, while the welfare state is very horrible, it is not an excuse to call for limiting people's freedom of movement. And I would really like it if many libertarians would stop using that for justification.
Well, they're not really libertarians, are they, though? Let's like just be honest about that fact.
Well, I can understand why people believe that if you increase the amount of immigrants to the country by tenfold and you kept in place all the social welfare programs that are in place now, that you would see a real stress on those things. I mean, doesn't that seem reasonable, Eric?
Well, for one, it's for the whole principle behind it, because we're taught from a very early age that two wrongs don't make it right, for one. And so the time that, you know, we could be, instead of trying to call for limiting other people's freedoms, we could be dealing with ending the welfare state. And
can't you just use the reality that people should be able to cross, free people should be able to cross the borders of free countries freely? Can't you use that reality to springboard the elimination of social welfare programs that immigrants might use to and break the country? Why can't it both be done at the same time?
Yeah, and also you had actually made this argument probably a few years ago. I believe when you and Ian were on the Alex Jones show debating this, and I use this quite very often. It was very good that having a militarized border and rounding people up is very expensive as well, and would also give, I think, where many people would be afraid of just how, you know, these immigrants would vote and how much bigger government and less freedoms. Where I think this policy would be. Whereas that scenario might be a probability, it might happen, but I think with these policies of, as I mentioned, militarizing the border and interfering with other people, with business hiring practices, that we can say is a certainty that will give us what people want are afraid of.
Well, what I proposed the other, I guess it's been about a week or so ago on the air, was this blue card. As opposed to a green card, this blue card would allow basically anybody who wanted to come into the country. I think that it's probably reasonable that people will want to see people's, I don't know, checked for drug resistance tuberculosis or something. But, you know, just about everybody, 99% of the people would be able to come here. But this, if they accept the blue card, they would be ineligible for all social welfare programs. And I mean all of them, not just, you know, the things we call welfare. But
they wouldn't be able to use roads,
schools. I would say schools, roads. I'd say certainly be able to use roads. You'd have to be able to get around. But roads are paid for largely by taxes in the sense of gas taxes. They'd be paying that.
What about public transportation? Because that's kind of welfare.
Yeah, I can see the argument for public transportation, but it already runs in the red. And, you know, the buses are going to cost just as much if they're full of immigrants as if they're not full of immigrants. So I would say buses are okay. I think that that's the best way to go, because then you don't have people worrying about it. Look, let's start an immigration program where immigrants aren't allowed to have the social welfare programs that you believe they're using so much. And then the person's argument is stuck, because then they have to say, okay, that's a good idea. or they have to say, but they're taking our jobs. At which point you can tell them, you can explain economics to them, which is to say, it's not your job. A job is an agreement between two people. And if you don't have an agreement between two people, that's like saying your wife who divorced you has ruined your marriage. No, you both did. So it's an agreement, and that's it. If I don't want to employ somebody, if somebody comes along that's a better choice for me to employ to mow my grass, then the guy who mowed my grass previously is not, he doesn't lose anything because it's my ability as a consumer to decide those things. Your thoughts, Eric?
Yeah, I would agree. Pretty much covers everything I have to say, but yeah, I just would really hope that just more libertarians would stop using it. Even anarchists, even some self-professed anarchists use that argument as well.
Well, anybody can call themselves anything. So appreciate it, Eric. 855-450-3733. Immigration is a big issue right now, especially with Trump, getting so much campaign mileage out of it.
Yeah, and he wants to force the Mexicans to pay for the wall that he's going to hire.
That's about the
China to build.
Bigotedest thing I've ever heard anyone say. Really? You think the Mexican government's going to build your wall, you blowhard? Yeah, they might build a wall around your butt and hold you in prison in it, but that's about the only wall they're going to be building.
We could only be so lucky.
While you say they're a bunch of rapists and criminals.
Yeah.
Well, I hire the Chinese to do all my my clothing lines, and I'll...
It's made in Mexico, actually, is clothing lines.
Actually, no, that's where they formerly used to have the clothing, and then I changed that because I don't like those Mexicans. So I have the Chinese building my clothes now, and I think that they can do the wall as well. I've had it on good authority that they've done this before.
That they've made a wall?
Yes.
Well, here's what I want to know. If you would support the idea of a wall, by the way, the number is 855-450-3733. Can you answer this question for me? And when you call in to advocate for your wall and tell me why your wall is going to be the best immigration choice, can you tell me, can you, like, enlighten me on history? Because I really don't know. What do you think the East Berliners were told when the Soviets were building a wall around East Berlin? Were they being told it's to keep them safe from those bad people out there? I mean, I just don't really know. There's a wall that was built, and it kept people in. 855-450-3733, 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
Okay, open your mouth and say, ah. When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor-recommended Say-Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue, and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical-grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahnow.com. Sayahnow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug-out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Many are in disbelief today after word of shocking allegations against a Minnesota-based talk syndication company known as GCN. It's claimed that they're the fourth largest talk syndication company in the U.S., making it even more scandalous that they've been accused of helping business owners expose themselves on a massive scale. Let's go live to Tom for more on this story.
It's being called the greatest exposure of our lifetime, while other business owners are beginning to step forward claiming they too exposed themselves with the help of GCN.
It's true. They're all guilty. Every last one of them. GCN helped me get the exposure my company needed, and just think, that was years ago. Today, GCN has like 700 affiliate stations and over 6 million downloads from iTunes and their website every month.
Imagine the exposure your company can get. Expose your business to the masses. Email advertise at GCNlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective. GCN.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Hi, my name is DeRay, suffering from migraines, having Botox injections in my head and neck to alleviate pain, costing $1,500 out of my pocket. I discovered Dr. Ortman and Gentle Touch Chiropractic Adjustment called NUCA. I'm migraine-free since my first adjustment. Thanks for giving me my life back, Dr. Ortman. I wish they prescribed you instead of Botox.
Thanks, DeRay. Putting the bones back in place is only half of the solution. We design a nutritional supplement program the body can handle, actually absorb, providing nutrients targeting the problem area. Between NUCA and nutrition, we will have you on the road to a faster and more permanent recovery. Look us up on the web at drortman.com or call 952-303-9124. Let us help you feel better faster. Wellspring Spinal Care at 952-303-9124. Again, that's 952-303-9124. Or on the web at drortman.com.
Do you owe the IRS money? Has the IRS garnished your wages or put a lien against your house? The IRS has the power to make you pay back what they claim you owe and will stop at nothing to collect. There is a solution. Call Signature Tax now. Speak with our professionals and feel the weight of your tax burden lifted from your shoulders. Call now for your free and confidential analysis. 800-481-3147. Again, that's 800-481-3147. 800-481-3147.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. We've talked about global warming and border walls and all the, all the tried and true good stuff that they talk about on talk radio programs, right? Yeah, they talk about that stuff.
Yeah.
We mentioned Donald Trump. I mean, these are the things they're talking about these days.
We didn't mention his toupee.
It's not a toupee. Yet. It's a comb over. You know, come on.
It's a small rodent.
It's a wombat.
Known as the toupee.
What was the name? What was the name from the creatures, the rodents of unusual size from the Princess Bride?
RUSs. Ones of unusual size.
Never heard of it.
You haven't seen Princess Bride?
Oh. Really? I thought you were making the reference.
Oh, I was.
I thought Daryl was.
No, okay.
Rodents of Unusual Size?
Well, go out and watch that. It's the best movie ever made.
I don't believe they exist.
Bitcoinist.net is the ultimate resource for Bitcoin industry news, reviews, education, and the latest in the cryptocurrency ecosystem. They've got breaking news for Bitcoin and digital currencies. Their website integrates a community forum. They've also cover fintech and blockchain tech news as well. They've got sophisticated network statistics for Bitcoin, a solid beginner's guide, and much more. Their platform serves the needs of everyone looking to keep up with Bitcoin and digital currencies, from beginners to experts. Bitcoinist.net. That's Bitcoinist.net. Let's go to the phones and talk to Miles. Miles, you're on Free Talk Live on Skype.
Hey, how you doing, Mark, Daryl, and Johnson? You guys are also one of my favorite non-Ian groups. Very entertaining.
Isn't Ian only on off one night, so therefore we're the only non-Ian group?
I guess so, yeah.
Currently in existence. There have been previous non-Ian groups of hosts.
All right. So you like this co-host.
Yeah. I love you guys. But you know, my main concern, my main problem is that, you know, we're always talking about this whole contrived border issue. We're always talking about Donald Trump and mainstream politics. And to be honest, it's just all so fake, you know?
And it's like professional wrestling.
Yeah, well, every once in a while, I'd like it. Maybe if you guys could talk about something less fake, like, you know, maybe pro wrestling or something. you know?
Yeah, I get it.
So Daryl, I want to know a couple things. Is Dean Ambrose your favorite wrestler?
I like Dean Ambrose. I'm a big Daniel Bryan fan. Hopefully he comes back from his neck
surgery. I'll explain to Mark. Okay, so Dean Ambrose is the lunatic. They call him the Lunatic Fringe. He's the anarchist character.
Yes.
His
logo is actually an anarchy symbol with the letter D instead of a circle. Yeah. So his initial D.A., Dean Ambrose.
Gotcha.
So he's not like the kind of anarchist that anarcho, you know, he's the very Hollywood anarchist. So he's like completely unhinged.
Here's a little news for
black.
You. That is the definition of an anarchist. Just so you know, if a
word
is used in a certain way sufficiently by society, that then becomes the definition of the word.
No, so, it's not. It's not really.
Deny it all you wish, sir.
It becomes the colloquial definition.
Tell you what, do this. Go on, get an anonymizer. That way your searches on Google or tell you what, use startpage.com. That way you're not using your results won't be skewed. Go to startpage.com, search the word anarchist or anarchy, and read the top three results as though you know nothing about the word. And then you will know what
you'll
the word
what the
anarchy
media,
in fact means.
Yeah, no, you'll know what the media considers the word to mean.
All right,
man. I think at this point, there's probably more anarcho-capitalists and libertarians that consider anarchism in a completely different context than this crazed out lunatic like Dean Ambrose. So anyways, that's
Those
my stance on it.
Those people are voluntarists. They just don't like the word.
Yeah, we can go with that. Before I go, I remember back a few weeks ago, Ian mentioned that Daryl, you supposedly got through a checkpoint, like when a DUI checkpoint or a border checkpoint or something, by just repeating the word "what" over and over.
Yeah, so it was one of these internal checkpoints on Interstate 10 near El Paso. It was when I was moving from Sedona, Arizona to San Antonio, Texas. Had everything I owned that I could fit in my car. I'm driving, and the guy keeps asking, "You an American citizen? What? Are you an American citizen? What?" And after like four times, he just waved me through.
And you got that from Stone Cold Steve Austin, right?
No, not really. I just didn't feel like dealing with the guy and wanted to see what would happen.
Okay, my bad. A couple of those times you had said K.
Well, that's probably the guy just heard your accent and he's like, "Well, look, he's not from Canada. He's not from Australia. He's not from England. He certainly doesn't look like he's from Jamaica. So I'm just going to go ahead and wave him through." This is one of those things that when people, you know, have a conversation with a border guard and, you know, you say something, that even the ones that are doing the internal checkpoints, and you say things like, it's my Fourth Amendment and Fifth Amendment and Seventh Amendment rights not to answer your questions. I shan't be answering them. I'll only open my window a crack, sir. Am I free to go? Am I being detained? Right? Like, you know, you're not talking like that because you're from Guatemala.
Right.
So you've answered their question without answering the question. At that point, it's just a dominance game after that.
Right. So to sort of give a tangential story, I watched the most recent Stone Cold podcast, and he actually relays the story of how the "what" chant became like a big thing in WWE. So if you get a chance, the Stone Cold podcast, where Edge and Christian were his guest. totally okay, awesome. Reeks of awesomeness.
Yeah, and I'll definitely have to check that out. But before I go, you guys, can you just talk about for a second, like, is it just me, or is this whole the whole mainstream political stage, is it really as fake as it seems like it is? No. To me?
This is real life, man. This is what people are voting for. This is what people are rooting for. This is real life. This is the political process.
You don't think Trump is an entertainer?
Where was the entertainer in 2008 and 2012?
Well, I mean, it's there's a quote by Frank Zappa, I think, where he says that mainstream politics is basically the entertainment wing for the military-industrial complex.
Yeah, I think that's a great
quote. Disagree with that?
Do I disagree with it?
Yeah.
I think that Frank Zappa was too intelligent for the time in which he's lived. So I would say that I don't know what you mean when you're asking that. Do I think it is largely irrelevant which way you vote, meaning that his statement would then be true? Yes, I do agree with that. However, somebody is going to be president in 2016, and that person, I believe, will likely be the person who garners the most votes. I don't believe the system is so rigged that it doesn't matter, that they don't count votes. So, I mean, it's real in that sense.
But is it real? Like, are they really playing for different teams?
Yes, they are playing for different teams. They disagree with each other on a modicum of issues. The things that they do agree with is that there shouldn't be third parties involved. They shouldn't, that the government is really the answer to just about every question. But they have different answers to the questions on how the government should take care of
it. I would say that it's different teams, as in the offense and the defense of the San Francisco 49ers are different aspects of the San Francisco 49ers. Republicans and Democrats both playing for the government.
Same team. Thank you.
855 450 free. Free Talk Live.
Retrievers, Labradors, Goldens are the main breeds that come through our door, but we'll train anything with four legs and a tail. My husband and I train hunting dogs and also have a boarding and grooming business. And our dogs, they're athletes, and we feed them very quality food. You can't get enzymes in a commercial dog food because they cook it at such a high heat, but adding Dynavite to their diet has every single dog in my kennel looking better than they have ever looked.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
Dynavite's the bomb.
You tell everybody we know about Dynavite.
Just feed your dog right. Use Dynavite. If it's working, don't quit.
When I get down to the bottom of my box of Dynavite, it's time to place my order.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey System. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting GoBerkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Hey, neighbor, what are you doing digging? You had a heart attack last year.
Oh, I know. I was told no more hard labor.
Then why are you digging?
Well, I've been taking Extendivite. It's been approved to help my heart.
Extendivite? Is that a new drug?
No, not a drug. It's more like an herbal combination made from garlic and cayenne.
Herbal? How can that help?
Well, actually, we've taken herbs for thousands of years. Extendivite is doing the job for me.
Does your doctor know about Extendivite?
Yeah, my doctor knows, and he said it seems to be working for you, so don't stop taking it. I feel great taking Extendivite. I don't want to stop.
To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822. Or visit our website at heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendivite.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Yeah! Free Talk Live. I'm waiting for the come on. There it was. 855-450-3733. I know these music beds. I know them. 855-450-FREE. We've been talking about global warming, the border wall, the election process, is it rigged or not? Those kind of things. 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever you want, as evidenced by, oh, by the way, I want to tell you real quick, you can get archives of Free Talk Live going back for many years at archives.freetalklive.com. They're completely free. If you need more audio content than we provide you in a week, which is 21 hours, go there and get it. I guess it's not 21 hours. More like
Absent the commercials, it's about 15.
Yeah, 14, 15. Libertarian Banker, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys. How's it going tonight?
All's well. What's up with you?
Want to talk about the car loan bubble. I called in the other night about the student loan bubble. And one thing I see is people that borrow way too much money on their cars. As a lender, you know, I try to advise people to, you know, make a good choice as to the type of loan they get. But people are going longer and longer with the terms, and all they want is a low payment. And, you know, this is creating basically a bunch of unsecured debt, because as the value of these cars go down, the loan is not keeping up with that depreciation.
Yeah, my wife bought a car, and we got it for sort of safety reasons, and probably all the reasons you've heard. But for whatever reason, you know how these dealers are. They sent me a piece of paper saying your car's extra valuable. We'd love to talk to you about trading it in. Right? You know how that they do that, which is just saying that, hey, come in to talk to us about a new car, and we'll talk to you about your trade in. Which is, you know, it's just a tactic. It's a tactic, people. But anyway,
absolutely,
it got me thinking. Hold on. It got me thinking about, well, is this it is an unusual car, since it's a plug-in Prius. I'll give them a call. So I did actually give them a call. Of course, they wanted me to come in, and I'm like, nope, I'm sitting here at my desk. Why don't you tell me what my car's worth? And it turned out basically the answer was that you can turn it in, and the payments that you've paid will go for nothing. You have no equity, and I have no equity in the car at all. And essentially that it's worth currently what the value of the payments remaining are. So
exactly. And this, you know, culture of consumerism, and, you know, basically people ask how much down and how much a month. And what that does is people start leasing cars too. And that is one of the most expensive ways to operate a vehicle, unless you have a business, in which case, you know, it might make sense from a write-off standpoint. But
what is the least expensive way to operate a vehicle?
Well, from a monthly perspective, absolutely.
What is the least expensive way to operate a vehicle?
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you said least. the least expensive way is to pay cash for a car.
A new car?
To buy maybe a 2 or 3 year old car, pay cash for it, or get a small loan on it for maybe 3 or 4 years. And instead of 7 or 8.
All right. So, Libertarian Banker, I've got a question for you. One of the first things you said was people, when they get a loan, they just want a low payment. Have you ever had somebody come in for a loan and say, what's the absolute highest payment I can make because I don't want a low payment?
Why would they say that?
No. I have had really savvy clients who actually have money that ask, how much is the interest going to cost me? And that's a huge factor when you look over the life of a 7 or 8 year loan. When you look over the life of a 3 year loan, the amount of interest drops significantly. So that's what rich people do. They borrow money on used cars for 3 years rather than new cars for 8 years.
I see. You know, the reason dealers are in business is because they make it easy to buy a new car.
Yes.
Frankly, the first new car I've ever owned is the one that my wife has. I don't own it. I mean, she does. But the first new car I've ever had the pleasure of paying off is the one that my wife owns currently. And I'm not buying a new car until it drives itself. That's what I've said up to this point. When the car drives itself, then I might be interested.
And Peter Schiff, actually on his podcast the other day, brought up a good point, is that a lot of these dealers will offer you an incentive when you drive off the lot. So you're driving off the lot with a brand new car, not having to pay a dime, and you got $500 in your pocket and a Visa gift card.
Sometimes I'll do that. So I want to compare the student loan bubble to the car loan bubble. You have me convinced in the car loan bubble that too many people have too much debt out there on cars. Then again, I don't imagine it's that much different than it has been in the past. But it's unsecured. The student loan bubble, it's kind of secured because people can't they can't file bankruptcy or anything. If they've got a job, their wages are going to be garnished for these student loans. How are these both bubbles?
Well, I think the bubble comes to the fact that the government is pumping up the student loan market by offering guarantees to banks and other financial companies. Instead of making loans based off of a person's income and credit score and credit worthiness, we're making loans based off of a government guarantee. And I mean, that's very powerful in the market. And that's where the student loan bubble comes from.
So is the student loan bubble just going to slowly deflate because people are going to more and more say, I can't afford this? They're just going to say it's not worth going to college? Or is it going to...
Yeah, hey, either that or Bernie Sanders will get elected and we'll just forgive it all.
Well, Bernie Sanders can't get elected with his platform when I'm running against him offering double. Whatever Bernie Sanders says, I offer double.
I'm not voting for you then, Mark.
There you go. 855, because I don't care.
Well, hold on. So let me ask this question. Are you only doubling what Bernie is offering, or are you also doubling what Vermin Supreme is offering? I get two ponies or one?
When I get into office, we are going to find out just how much free crap the United States economy can take. We're going to see what the welfare state does. I'm going to kick it up into the red zone. And then we'll just find out how well socialism works.
You're not telling me how many ponies.
All the ponies you want, buddy. We get a pony of every color. Thanks. Woo-hoo! Thanks for the call, Libertarian Banker.
Absolutely. How many strippers?
855-450-3733. Daryl, I'm not sure a stripper that I can handle the stripper bubble that would come in play having to pay them to be around you, buddy. 855-450-3733.
Just go see Libertarian Banker, get a loan, find out what the lowest payment you can make, and then he gets all that interest money.
Tell me about this global warming article we started out with that it didn't get anywhere on.
Yeah, so there were some scientists that decided, you know what, we want to take a crack at some of these studies that claim that humans are not the sole cause of global warming. And, well, their claim is, well, they're cherry-picking data, and they ignored 6,000 years' worth of information.
Okay.
So one of the people that headed up this team wrote something in The Guardian that says, when we tried to reproduce their model of the lunar and solar influence on the climate, we found that the model only simulated their temperature data reasonably accurate for the 4,000-year period they considered. However, for the 6,000 years worth of earlier data they threw out, their model could not reproduce the temperature changes. The authors argued that their model could be used to forecast future climate changes, but there's no reason to trust a model's forecast if it cannot accurately reproduce the past.
So the suggestion is that these climate deniers' model could not reproduce the past, but the climate change
advocates... Well, it accurately reproduced the 4,000-year period that they reproduced, but it did not reproduce the 6,000 years worth of climate stuff that happened before the beginning of the 4,000-year period.
So I guess my question would be then, aren't they the climate change advocates and the climate change deniers on completely equal ground then? Because if the climate change deniers model can't predict the past and the climate change
advocates,
their model seems to be completely unable to predict the future because they've been being wrong for the past several years, right?
Yeah.
I mean, the planet's been cooling when they keep saying it's going to warm.
Right.
It's like, oh, look, it's not warming over and over and over again.
Yeah, the one thing that I keep coming back to on this this issue of anthropogenic global climate change is that I tend to agree that with the scientists that this thing is happening. However, I think the worst group of people to come up with a solution are the world's governments.
Yes.
So whatever the problem is, I trust scientists, inventors, engineers, these people to solve it better, quicker, and with fewer problems than I do any of the world's governments.
I'm sure we're just going to mess it up more. I mean, what's going to happen is we're going to invent carbon scrubbers that can remove carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, and then we're going to go overboard.
We have carbon scrubbers. They're called trees. 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
When the leading antihistamine and Nasacort go nose-to-nose, Nasacort wins, stopping more of the chemical responses that can cause your nasal allergy symptoms. And when you stop more causes, you get 24-hour relief from sneezing, an itchy runny nose, even congestion. It's prescription-strength medicine available over-the-counter. Nasacort Allergy 24-hour. Stops more of what makes you miserable. Use as directed.
There comes a time when you need custom embroidered or screen printed apparel for your business, organization, or a special event. Corporate Casuals has been helping people create great looking logoed apparel for over 25 years. They can produce a single piece or thousands using name brand apparel like Nike, Patagonia, Adidas, and Hanes. Create your logo in their online embroidery design studio or upload your existing logo and they'll turn it into embroidery. Go to corporatecasuals.com/FTL and include FTL in the order notes and save 5% on your order.
Mike Stenerson from Midas Resources. At no time in history have precious metals been more important, certainly not in my 22 years in the industry. The dollar has lost over 90% of its value in the last 60 years. No fiat currency has ever survived the government printing presses. Ours is not immune. The time is now to be proactive. 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Anything tied to the dollar is at risk. CDs, annuities, 401ks, IRAs, stocks, bonds, you name it. So decide. Do you want to leave a legacy of wealth or debt for your family? The choice is yours. Call me at 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. That's 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Be proactive, not reactive. Call 1-800-686-2237, extension 116.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Be sure to visit GCNlive.com today.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. Senate Democrats have been able to stave off a resolution of disapproval against President Obama's Iran nuclear deal. Senate Minority Leader Harry Reid says the vote means the agreement has survived the GOP challenge.
The Senate has spoken, and they've spoken with a clarion voice and declared that the historic agreement to prevent Iran from obtaining a nuclear weapon will stand.
But Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell says it's a shame Democrats wouldn't allow the measure to come for a final vote.
Democratic senators just voted to filibuster and block the American people from even having a real vote on one of the most consequential foreign policy issues of our time.
Beginning next week, President Obama will be free to start scaling back U.S. sanctions to implement the agreement negotiated by Iran, the U.S., and five other world powers. The Obama administration announced today that it will admit some 10,000 Syrian refugees into the United States. White House Press Secretary Josh Earnest says the refugees to be admitted next fiscal year is a big jump over this year's 1,500, but it hardly solves the crisis.
We know the scale of this problem. It's significant. And there are millions of people who have been driven from their homes because of this violence.
The White House has been under heavy pressure to do more than just provide money to help meet the humanitarian crisis in Europe, where hundreds of thousands have swarmed over the borders. The top-ranking Democrat in the House says she is confident that Hillary Clinton didn't violate any laws by using a personal email server while Secretary of State.
I've always thought that she would never have sent or received any email that would be top secret or confidential or whatever the category happened, classified.
Meanwhile, the former State Department employee who installed and maintained Mrs. Clinton's email server pleaded the Fifth Amendment today at a House hearing. On Wall Street, the Dow by 77 points, the Nasdaq rose 40. More on these stories at townhall.com.
Got a lot on your to-do list? Now, during Kubota's Power to Do Great Things sales event, get a great deal on an L3301 or 3901 tractor with a live continuous running rear PTO. Now get financing as low as 0% APR for up to 5 years, and great customer instant rebates when you buy a new L3301 or 3901 and two implements. Now through September 30th, 2015. Call toll-free 1-888-465-8268 for details about cost and terms. For more information or to find a participating dealer, visit Kubota.com.
I'm a pair of designer shoes so expensive, my owner had to give up half decaf skim vanilla lattes just to afford me. So you can imagine my terror when a pipe burst and the apartment started flooding. There I was, trapped in the closet, water rushing all around me. But what was I to do? I'm a 6-inch stiletto. It's not like I can run.
Your stuff can't protect itself. That's why the GEICO Insurance Agency helps make it easy to switch and save on renter's insurance. Renter's insurance will cover personal property loss or damage as well as provide liability protection. Visit GEICO.com today.
One person in Texas has died in connection to a salmonella outbreak that is linked to recalled cucumbers.
The Texas Department of State Health Services says the cucumbers came from California. An investigation found that there have been a total of 18 salmonella cases in Texas alone. The person who died in August also had serious underlying health issues. A national recall was issued recently for cucumbers distributed by a California company under the limited edition brand name. Val Dior reporting.
The search for a suspect in a string of Phoenix freeway shootings took on a frenzied pace today as police jumped from one spot to another, investigating five more reports of vehicles being shot as a panicked public flooded a hotline with tips. Police confirmed one of those reports, raising to 11 the number of vehicles struck on Phoenix area freeways since August 29th. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. Republican presidential hopeful Bobby Jindal took on GOP frontrunner Donald Trump during a press conference at the National Press Club in Washington today. Jindal says by flirting with Donald Trump, the GOP is risking its chance at the White House.
Are we going to miss this great opportunity? Are we going to apply conservative principles? Or do we trust a man who believes in nothing but himself? That's what makes Donald Trump so dangerous.
Jindal says it's time for the GOP to shut down Trump and his carnival act.
The silly summer season is over. It's time to get serious about saving our country. It's time to send Donald Trump back to reality TV.
That may be difficult to do. In the latest CNN ORC poll, Trump has recently surged to lead the GOP pack with 32% support. But the new poll also shows Dr. Ben Carson rising 10 points to land in second place in the GOP race with 19%. More on these stories at townhall.com.
Silver has always been nature's very own antibiotic, and only one system allows you to produce an endless supply of nano-sized silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. Silver Lungs. With the addition of our unique lung delivery system, respiratory infections are targeted directly, where traditional oral administration simply cannot reach. This pioneering method also preserves the original particle sizes and delivers your silver solution directly into the bloodstream. See the Silver Lungs generator and lung delivery system at silverlungs.com. That's silverlungs.com.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Free Talk Live.
It's Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. I've wanted to know, and I've wanted to know for years, is this whole global climate change bunk? How much of is it true? How much of it is false? One of the reasons we don't talk about it much here on Free Talk Live is that science, Free Talk Live is a talk show. Science isn't up for debate. So, Daryl, you brought in, apparently there's some folks, some scientists have gotten...
Seven scientists
have taken all the studies, the 80 studies that have said that global...
Not all of them.
Excuse me, 40 of the 80?
It says about half.
So about 40 of the 80 studies that say that global climate change is bunk, and these are the 40 most popularly cited ones, they have looked at them and come to the conclusion that those studies themselves were bunk, so meaning that, therefore, the global climate change is likely, anthropogenic global climate change is likely true.
So the first, they made three main points. The first was that the climate change deniers cherry-pick data, and they claim, well, they only looked at 4,000 years of history, not the 6,000 years before that, so therefore,
bonk. I don't think that's the
strongest
point. I mean, I just kind of feel like, you know, 4,000 years worth of data is pretty good.
Right. Climate change deniers ignore basic scientific facts, is the second claim they make. While most papers misconstrue or left out or simply ignored some core scientific facts, a handful of papers blamed climate change on the orbits of Jupiter and Saturn, but the researchers did not offer an explanation of how that could possibly be done in the first place. Other studies argued that greenhouse gases that fuel climate change, including carbon dioxide, don't drive global warming much beyond a particular saturation point, which would let humans off the hook for adding more and more to the atmosphere. However, that idea was disproven as far back as the early 1900s. The third point they make is climate change deniers can't agree on an alternative theory.
Well, that doesn't mean that climate change is real just because the opposition can't come up with a reason why it's not. That's like saying, you know, my God, the flying spaghetti monster is real because you don't have an alternative. That's bold.
But there's thousands of alternatives.
Yes, I understand.
But you don't agree on the alternative.
Right. That is bad. That is a bad reason right there.
Yes, I agree. They write, while 97% of experts agree that humans are worsening climate change, the other 3% could not settle on an alternative explanation. Nusatelli, who's the guy that headed up the team, says the 2-3% of papers...
Point, hold on just a second. So that's, they're saying that climate change is real, just that humans aren't the cause. So we're at nearly 100% of climate change scientists saying climate change is real. It's just we don't know exactly what the reasons are.
Right. I don't know anybody that's saying we're still in the midst of an ice age that existed 10,000 years ago.
I just want to make that clear because that not everybody who's listening even agrees that far. And
saying that you think there are people that are saying we're still in an ice age that existed 10,000 years ago and glaciers still cover the middle of the United States?
No, I'm not saying that.
Then that would be what you're saying. If somebody is saying that there is no such thing ever as climate change, that the climate has never changed in the history of the world, then that would mean that there are still glaciers in the middle of the United States right now.
No, there are people claiming that the climate has not warmed in the last 20 years. Johnson, weren't you quoting some numbers out there that say something to that effect, that the climate hasn't changed in, the last 20 years?
In the last 20... I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay. I've seen folks say that in the last 10 years, there hasn't been, the warmest year was 2006. I don't know exactly what year it was. And it hasn't been warmer since then. And, things like that. So, yes, there are definitely people that are making the claim that it's not getting, that the world isn't getting warmer. Now they're not claiming it's still an ice age. That would be taking it to the other extreme. They're just saying in the last 20 years, we haven't seen a marked increase in temperatures. Whereas when I see, oceanographic scientists talking about the seas becoming more acidic, when I see the Northwest Passage has opened up in Canada, they're taking boats north of Canada and the variety of things, I see, looks like the world's getting warmer. I wonder why. People say Mars is getting warmer, too. That suggests it's not humans. People say the sun's warmer. Okay, that's interesting.
There are solar flares that happen, and there's direct evidence that links various warming trends to solar activity. And that partially explains why the ice caps on Mars have melted and then refrozen. So the person that headed up this team of seven scientists and meteorologists says the 2-3% of papers that reject the consensus are all over the map, even contradicting each other. The one thing they seem to have in common is methodological flaws like cherry picking, curve fitting, ignoring inconvenient data, and disregarding known physics. The researchers say science is constantly evolving and changing, so no area of research is ever really finished. However, science is based on evidence. Enough evidence leads to a theory, and a theory that survives when it is tested over and over again and the evidence continues to support it. Then the scientific community comes to a consensus on that theory. That's how 97% of experts came to agree on the theory that climate change is fueled by human activity, a conclusion that's been over a century in the making.
Yeah, I kind of feel like the both sides are overstating that's what I've said all along. It seems like, yes, there's some effect from humans on the environment.
Yes.
That seems to be the case. No, I do not think that it is going at the – if we don't turn this around in the next 5 years – all human life will be wiped out in 30 years. Like these kind of radical claims that have been trotted out.
Right, like some of the Al Gore theories that he trotted out in an Inconvenient movie.
Never watched it.
Where he, one of the things he had said was, I believe by this year, Washington, D.C. was going to be completely underwater.
Yeah, well, you see, that was one of the problems with making claims like this. Is that some point or another, somebody can show you that it's just not true. I mean, look at Back to the Future, for instance.
Yeah, that was not trouted as a documentary.
Well,
Al Gore's movie was trouted as a documentary. Now, Idiocracy, on the other hand, is clearly a documentary.
May very well be a documentary.
Welcome to Costco. I love you.
So that's the end of the article. Basically, that's it.
The claim is anthropogenic global warming is real because the people that say it's not have different theories and they don't agree.
Yeah, I don't.
Therefore, we're right and they're not.
I find it slightly convincing, but not terribly convincing, you know?
Right.
I mean, at this point, I already had the position that anthropogenic global warming was real. I just don't know how real it is.
I would say on the micro level, it can be seen. So, for instance, a lot of the stuff happening in California is directly because of human involvement in the environment. So you've got lakes and you're drawing all of this water out of the lake, and then you've got a drought added on top of that, and it's like, there's no more water in the lake.
It's going to be a bad day.
You know, that's obviously connected to humans, but is the fact that people are drawing water out of lakes and diverting water from rivers that go to the lake, does that cause a severe snowstorm in New England?
Well, the claim is that they're taking a bunch of fossil fuels out of the ground, and I'm not even sure that fossil fuels are made out of fossils, but fossil fuels are being taken out of the ground, burned, carbon's being emitted as a result, and the atmosphere can't handle that much carbon. One thing they don't mention is that in a environment of extra carbon, trees and plants do better.
Yes.
So I don't think that ever gets figured into the models. And I think that's one of the reasons that it's not things aren't occurring as quickly as the doomsayers are saying. What are your thoughts? 855-450-3733. Free Talk Live. 855-450-FREE. Or you can use Skype. Our username is lrn.fm. And the landline is 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC.com.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor, period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat-rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CatiArmor.com. Come and take it.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in and address the myriad of issues that we've covered this evening, from global warming to the border wall to the vote being rigged to the new car bubble. It's Mark with you.
Daryl.
And Johnson.
855-450-3733 or
855-450-FREE.
Or LRN.FM on Skype.
So the real question is, what does the new car bubble smell like?
I don't know. We'll see. Let's go to John calling in from Nevada. John, you're on Free Talk Live. Try it again. John, you're on Free Talk Live. For some reason, I can't board up. I can't put John on the air. I don't know what's happening here.
Hi, guys.
Hey, what's going on?
I've never understood why people think it's important whether warming is anthropogenic.
Okay.
Man-made or not. It seems to me that the things that are important are, is warming happening? Is it dangerous? And is there anything that can be done about it?
Right. I think that that's the anthropogenic part sort of answers to some extent, if humans are causing it. And I think that this is one of those areas where I can say, if we are causing it, because, you know, Ian is hating the word we.
Because Ian's not a human?
Well, I don't know. We'd have to do some tests.
When Ian argued that he has a low carbon footprint,
I don't know. That
Don't include me in your we. I'm not causing global warming.
But if we are causing global warming, then we would be able to turn it around. If we are not causing it, then we wouldn't. I think might be the idea behind that.
But that doesn't sound right.
No, it's not right.
It would still be unknown whether we could stop it or not. So I don't think it's really that important. I think what necessary to understand. I think the temperature of the world is probably going up in a, mid to long term trend. Is it dangerous? How dangerous it is pretty unclear. But libertarians, maybe you guys could think about, well, if you thought it was really dangerous, and what would you want to be done about it? If you thought that, say within 50 to 100 years, it's going to be a massive problem unless major actions are taken now. So what would you favor then?
I don't have an answer.
Yeah, I don't have it. My thought on this is the same as my thought on, there's some asteroid that's going to smash into the planet and destroy things. Like, if it's going to happen, it's going to happen.
Lasers.
Yeah, if you look around the world today, the lion's share of the carbon dioxide production is going to be coming from the developing world, like China and right. India and Brazil. And so what's the option here? To lock them down? To go to war with them?
It's also kind of unfair that emerging the United States, when it was an emerging economy, got to do whatever it wanted as far as carbon goes. But now you're going to tell someplace like Bangladesh that, hey, you don't get to take the same path the United States did.
I mean, the ridiculous thing about this whole thing is that this problem is going to solve itself, period. The efficiency of solar cells is doubling every 2 years. Within the next decade, everyone's going to be using solar cells to power everything, period.
Unless I'm going to play devil's advocate here for a second and say that you're correct, unless governments intervene to protect the oil companies and basically hinder the solar economy from actually happening?
I don't know, man. I think they can try, but essentially, once the technology exists, it's energy. I mean, it's going to be self-powering. It's going to be a self-powering phenomenon. I mean, it's one of these things that 3D, that's something that can't be stopped. That's,
I'm hoping 3D printers can make solar cells at that point. At some point, that seems like that must be the case. And if that's the case, then then we don't need their power grid anymore.
Right.
Well, I've seen stuff where there's YouTube videos that shows you how to make a solar cell out of recycled aluminum cans and plexiglass and something else.
That might be to heat water, but that's not going to provide electricity.
No, there's some kind of way that you're hooking up a battery to something and doing it. And the claim is it works. I've not tried it.
I don't
know
how many aluminum cans you need to power your house. But
thousands.
It's going to be many, many aluminum cans.
Yeah, so it's not like, take one recycled aluminum can and put it here.
This digital clock.
Three beers a day for a year.
a giant stack of aluminum cans that the guy has to start the video. So, it's possible, not necessarily easy.
John?
Yeah. What drives me crazy is seeing politicians put forth programs and proposals that garner more power for them, but don't actually do anything to won't actually accomplish anything towards their supposed goal of stopping global warming, which makes you think that maybe they don't really have any concern with stopping global warming at all, but rather with just collecting political power.
It does seem like thank you so much for the call, John. Appreciate it. That does seem like what they try to do is, in every circumstance, but this is no different, is, look, here's a crisis. How can I use this to benefit me and my donors more? And then that's what they do.
I know. I'll create carbon credits.
Right. Carbon credits are a perfect example. The Solyndra situation where this company's given all this money and then finally goes under. It's just like a bunch of people got boats and left is essentially what appeared to happen. I don't know. When will we stop saying, there's a problem, let's turn it over to the government? How many times do you have to be screwed? I guess the problem is that the people who are asking for the solution aren't the ones who are getting screwed because they don't have money enough to really be screwed.
Right.
The amount of money that the government takes from poor people is inconsequential to the government, certainly, and to some extent to the poor people, too. Whereas the money that they take from rich people, it's much more consequential. If you want to see how divorced somebody can be from results, you give them other people's money to spend and don't let them, then don't have them, have any repercussions for the results.
Right.
At that point, when it's like, it doesn't matter what you pick and you're not spending your own money, it's like, give me nine of them in chartreuse, whatever. It's always going to be that way.
Yeah, and to sort of explain the way these carbon credit things sort of work, Mark, you're a pig farmer.
Yes, I am.
You've got pigs, so it'd be akin to, all right, we're creating bacon credits, and every man, woman, and child gets the same number of bacon credits. And, I don't have any pigs. I don't own pigs, so I have no use for my bacon credits that allow me to raise things to be turned into bacon. But I have these things, so... Well, what do you know, Mark? You need more bacon credits, so I sell my bacon credits to you, and then government gets a cut of all of the transactions of there, so Al Gore gets rich, you get more bacon credits, and I'm still left without any bacon.
It's just another tax. 855-450-3733.
Where's my bacon?
855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
Healthy, organic, fresh fish, robust, mouth-watering vegetables, all from your home. It's called aquaponics. This brilliant, self-sustaining protein and veggie system is perfect for year-round growing. Know exactly where your food is coming from. AquaponicsSource.com is the one-stop shop for all your needs. Fish, fish food, plumbing, full systems, classes, and more. Learn to build your own system. Go to AquaponicsSource.com for a free guide to aquaponics. That's AquaponicsSource.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Do you owe the IRS money? Do you have years of unfiled returns? Has the IRS garnished your wages or put a lien against your house? The IRS has the power to make you pay back what they claim you owe and will stop at nothing to collect. If you are losing sleep over your IRS tax problem, there is a solution. Call Signature Tax now. Speak with our professionals and feel the weight of your tax burden lifted from your shoulders. Call 800-643-4661 for your free and confidential analysis on ending your tax nightmare. We can help get your life back on track and give you the fresh start you deserve. Our A-plus BBB-rated tax resolution team has over 125 years of combined experience to get you the best deal possible while stopping the IRS dead in their tracks. Call Signature Tax now at 800-643-4661. Call 800-643-4661. Again, that's 800-643-4661. 800-643-4661.
By now, you know the smart way to buy emergency food storage is calories per dollar. Ready Supply Foods sells you 50% more food for your money. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. You need 2,000 calories per day under ideal conditions. Most 30-day kits don't have enough calories to sustain you for more than a week. They just don't have enough nutrition to do the job. See the comparisons for yourself at ReadySupplyFoods.com. We are the new leader in value and quality. Go to ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
Have you ever felt like the United States government knows way too much about your financial affairs? I continue to hear stories about property seizures, frozen bank accounts, confiscation of stocks and bonds. It makes me wonder if the U.S. citizen will ever again have the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Unfortunately, with the Drug and Money Laundering Act, the IRS Revenue Ruling 6045 of 1984, and the Trading with the Enemy Act and Franklin D. Roosevelt's Executive Order of 1933, some precious metal holdings are subject to government intervention. For this reason, Midas Resources has prepared a report explaining the boundaries of trading precious metals privately. Whether if you have any intention of trading with Midas Resources or not, I have instructed my representatives to give this report out free. Call for your free copy at 1-800-686-2237. When investing, always proceed with caution. Again, call 1-800-686-2237. Exercise your legal right to trade metals privately. 1-800-686-2237.
My name is Dell, and I live in El Cajon, California. I was concerned about my cholesterol readings because I knew that high cholesterol is related to clogging of the arteries and increases the risk for heart attack and stroke. One day, I heard an ad for Heart and Body Extract, and I was skeptical, but I decided to give it a try. Man, the numbers don't lie.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at hbextract.com.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-453. My name is Mark.
And this is Daryl.
And I'm Johnson.
855-453. You know, we've been all over the board this evening, from global warming to a border wall to the vote being rigged and new car bubble. And you can call in and comment on any of that. But I want to tell you about how you can help to maintain your privacy online. So privacy is important while you're on the internet. You need ProXPN. It's a virtual private network that encrypts all of your online data before it even gets to your internet service provider. So ProXPN does all that right. Does all of it right, offering OpenVPN, which is the gold standard of network encryption. They have apps for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android. There's even Linux support. Plus, unlike those other guys, ProXPN keeps no logs of your activities whatsoever. ProXPN has even more servers than ever before, giving you greater speed and security. They accept credit card and even Bitcoin. You can get 50% off of the regular monthly price for the lifetime of the account when you buy an annual account with our code FTL50. You actually save more with Bitcoin. It can end up being cheaper per month than a good cup of coffee. You keep hearing about our online privacy getting infringed, so go to proxpn.com now, use promo code FTL50, and take back the privacy that is your right. So I got here from QZ.com. Apparently, the Marines have done a little testing regarding mixed-gendered squads, and they don't look so great. Overall, the report says that all male teams and crews outperformed mixed-gendered teams and crews by 93 out of 134 tasks evaluated. All male teams were universally safer in each tactical movement. On lethality, the report says all male riflemen infantry squads had better accuracy compared to gender-integrated squads. There was a notable difference between genders for every individual weapon system. That includes the M1, the M27, the M203 within the squads, except for the probability of hit and near miss with the M4. So all male infantry crews served weapons, teams engaged targets quicker, registered more hits on target as compared to gender integrated infantry crew served weapons teams, and the exception of an M2 accuracy. And all male squads and teams and crews and gender integrated squads, teams and crews had a noticeable difference in their performance of basic combat tasks of negotiating obstacles, evacuating casualties. For example, when negotiating the wall obstacle, male Marines threw their packs to the top of the wall, whereas female Marines required regular assistance in getting their packs to the top. Bringing casualty evacuation assessments, there were notable differences in execution times between all male and gender integrated groups, except in the case where teams conducted a casualty evacuation as a one Marine fireman's carry of another, in which case it was most often a male Marine who evacuated the casualty anyway. So it turns out that this advocation for women in infantry and combat roles in the military might be a bad idea. I'm speaking as a fireman here. There are some women who can do the job, and there are all kinds of different jobs. But nature or God or whomever you wish to credit did not make the sexes equal when it comes to upper body strength. And right. So when you have a job that has to do with upper body strength, it's going to be a very unusual woman that is going to be able to outperform a pretty ordinary guy or group of guys. And I don't know why we have such a difficult time with that as a society. It seems like, yes, I'm all for any woman who can pass whatever the tests are, being in whatever the job is that they can pass the tests for. But I don't think we should have a different set of tests just because somebody has two X chromosomes or whatever the reason might be.
Yeah, there definitely shouldn't be two sets of tests.
I don't want to make things fair for overweight people who are getting into the military. They don't make things fair for overweight people getting in the military.
Actually, I've heard that they're making the test easier because there are so many obese teenagers.
That may be because they are finding that they have to do that in order to get the amount of recruits that they're looking for.
The first thing they tried is lowering the IQ requirements.
They've
raised
them back up. That was before the economic downturn. Lots of people signed up after that.
Right.
So they did lower the IQ requirements.
Right. I'm saying that's the first thing that they tried.
They tried a bunch of things throughout the years. There was a time when they'd let people avoid prison or jail in order to go into the military. They've tried all kinds of things throughout the years. But this isn't, they're not trying this because they need people to fill combat roles, Johnson. They're doing this because somebody says it's not fair. And look, it is fair. It's as fair as it could be. At least they could make it fair. They could say this is the set of requirements that it takes to be in the 509 infantry unit or whatever it is. And if you want to be in this particular unit, you have to pass these tests, and these tests include carrying a you know, a simulation dummy that weighs 200 pounds over your shoulders or whatever it is. I don't know what it is, but I can tell you, that as a firefighter, matter of fact, I can give you an example. There was a guy's house who was on fire. I happened to be first on the scene, and the fire chief pulls up right behind me in engine one. He hands me the hose, sends me in, says, "I don't care what you do, just put that fire out." Like there's no instructions, right. No nothing. And you know, I get the door open, the fire leaps out, I spray it down from the top to the bottom like I was taught. Fortunately, it was me and not some brand new guy, and I knew how to do it. But that hose, I had to, in order to advance with that hose, if I wanted to take a step forward up the steps into that guy's house, I had to stop the hose, pull it forward, and start it up again. Stop the hose, pull it forward, and start it up again. Because the hose was pushing that hard. If that had been I weigh just shy of 200 pounds, reasonably athletic at one point in my life, 44-year-old male, you know, like I can hold my own with a hose, as it were. That's going on, by the way. That's going to be going on Mark Edge Googling. But
Mark Edge Googling, how do you hold your own with a hose?
And then there's the real markedge.com. That is not me, people. He says outrageous things.
Also say outrageous things.
The Twitter, all he does is quote me, by the way.
So I take it these wonderful hoses cannot be turned partially off.
Yeah, they can be partially off. I mean, I would turn it down. Okay. It's just a throttle on the back. When I pull it back, it's open, and when it's forward, it's not. But in order to advance, I had to lower the pressure of the hose. So if somebody's not as strong as I am, they're not going to do as well. Now, women, when it comes to a hose, women can handle it by setting it down towards their hips. And that's going on Mark Edge Googling too. So there's ways to handle it, but that also doesn't allow you to sort of lean forward in the way that you need to. So
I
anyway.
Don't know if I can handle this hose. It's 128 feet long.
All right.
I've got to put it by my hips and then I can't lean forward.
All I'm saying is
you gotta control the hose by straddling it good.
Some jobs that men are just better equipped for than women. And I'm sure there's jobs that women are better equipped for than men. Have you ever noticed that when you go into some office environments that women are overrepresented? I have this belief, maybe I'm wrong here, and I wish there was some study on it, probably is some study on it that I've never seen before, is are women more organized? Maybe. Why do they have jobs that are office-oriented more than men do? Is it just that those are the jobs that are left, and so therefore they tend to be overrepresented in those areas?
Nobody's possibly.
I don't know.
Maybe. I don't even know idea.
I've done some research on the job sort of thing, trying to debunk the myth about women not earning the same as what men do.
You don't need to. Time already did that.
Right, but you know, like, look at the fields where women are overrepresented and they make less than the jobs where men are overrepresented.
What are your thoughts? 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
For P150, P150GA, P150LK, P150TN, C250A, C250E, C250Q. Not available in all states.
What's the scariest thing about going to the dentist? Opening your mouth or opening your wallet? Because just a simple cleaning can cost $100, and things like root canals can cost you hundreds more. If you don't have dental insurance to help, call Physicians Mutual Insurance Company, 1-800-809-5580. This isn't a discount plan or preventive-only coverage. This is real dental insurance that helps pay for checkups right away, so you can call today and get your teeth cleaned tomorrow. Plus, it helps cover the more expensive procedures you might need down the road. Fillings, crowns, bridges, even costly dentures. There's no deductible and no annual maximum. Your acceptance is guaranteed for one of these insurance policies, even if you're retired. There are no networks, so you can choose any dentist you'd like. Call in the next 10 minutes and we'll rush you a free information kit with all the details. 1-800-809-5580. That's 1-800-809-5580. 1-800-809-5580.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Do you owe the IRS money? Has the IRS garnished your wages or put a lien against your house? The IRS has the power to make you pay back what they claim you owe and will stop at nothing to collect. There is a solution. Call Signature Tax now. Speak with our professionals and feel the weight of your tax burden lifted from your shoulders. Call now for your free and confidential analysis. 800-481-3147. Again, that's 800-481-3147. 800-481-3147.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind. It's Mark with you.
Daryl.
And Johnson.
Liberty Health Share. This has been the solution at my house for Obamacare because I got to say, prices for insurance higher than we were prepared to pay. It just cost way too much, and I didn't know what to do about it. Well, Liberty Health Share, it was just a little over half what the cost of health insurance was, and you can pick your doctor, you can pick your hospital, and you don't have to participate in sort of the government's insurance-mandated scheme. It's an opt-out. LibertyHealthShare.org. You're still protected, but you've opted out. LibertyHealthShare.org, 855-558-LIBERTY. So it's 855-58-LIBERTY, LibertyHealthShare.org. And we have been so successful for them that they are coming on long term, and I'm really excited. That means a lot of people have been helped in the same way that, they're getting the same program that I am, or different ones. I mean, they've got different programs, but they're being helped like I am. LibertyHealthShare.org. Let's see. Oh, just a note. When you call in on Skype, there's no way for me to screen the call if you're I do it through typing. You got to tell me what your topic is when you call in. So just type in your topic when you call in on Skype, and the username there is lrn.fm. Johnson, I remember. Let's see. We had some article about. Trump, was it Trump not winning the election? There's no way for him to do it.
Okay, so that was Daryl that mentioned that. So Nate Silver, who is a statistician for ESPN, has an article that came out earlier today that says, calm down, Donald Trump will not win the GOP nomination.
I was calm, and I didn't think he was going to. Go ahead.
Well, I'm trying, but the webpage is frozen and not letting me scroll down to the article, so I'm trying to kill time here. Nate Silver, you may recall, is the founder and editor-in-chief of the journalism site 538.com. He also correctly predicted... It's a website that deals with the election stuff. 538 is the number of electoral votes.
You may remember that, or you may not.
Because yeah, I may not.
No idea what that site is.
I have no idea what that site is.
It's an election-related site.
Gotcha.
And 538 is the total number of electoral votes that are up for grabs during the presidential election. Nate Silver correctly predicted the winner of every state in 2012. So he correctly predicted which states Obama would win, which states Romney would win.
Which really is only predicting about seven states. What are they,
right.
Like 10 swing states, and you're just trying to look at which way they're going to go.
Right.
And honestly, even in those 10, 10 swing states, some of which are swingier than others, there's only a few swing counties. So you can really predict pretty closely which is going to go. Here, I'm going to make a prediction for next year. Vermont, Connecticut, and Rhode Island will all go blue in 2016.
Yeah, that's not really much of a prediction.
Well, there you go. Next year, I'll be able to say Mark Edge, who correctly predicted where the electoral votes would go for Vermont, Connecticut, and Rhode Island.
Yeah, no, this guy did it for all 50 states plus the District of Columbia.
All right, he's going to do some research. Go ahead.
So he is also one of the nation's top polling analysts. He told a journalist over at the 92nd Street Y in Manhattan, I don't think Donald Trump is very likely to win the nomination, in part because he's not really a Republican. He's very far to the right on immigration, but he also wants socialized medicine. Silver says he wants to tax the rich, right? There's an alternative reality in which he decided to run as a Democrat instead. He wouldn't have to change his policy positions all that much. Trump is the current front runner for the Republican nomination, leading in both national polls and polls of key early nominating states, including Iowa, New Hampshire, and South Carolina.
Trump's a diversion. He is a he's the flavor of the week. He's entertaining. He's a bear on a unicycle juggling beach balls.
That's offensive to bears on unicycles that juggle beach balls.
Yeah, well, they're not a big voting constituent, so I'm not worried.
I mean, Sim, who do you think is going to get the nomination? What is it going to be, Carson Fiorina? I mean, really, like, if it's not going to be Trump, who's massively in the lead right now, who's going to overshoot? Jeb? Because they're just going to make this thing fake? I mean, what's it going to be?
In 2008 and 2012, I just remember we went through presumed front runner after presumed front runner after presumed front runner.
That's not happening this time. It's been Trump.
It's been Trump for a while, and he's been exciting. But, we haven't even moved moved out of the summer yet. I just don't think it's...
Before Trump jumped in, Jeb was one of the presumed front runners. Rick Perry was a presumed front runner 3 years ago when people were prognosticating about 2016. So there's been a couple of presumed front runners, and Trump's been there for like the last 2 months. We're still 4 months away from the first primary election, so there's plenty of time.
Horrible thought for all the possible parodies here. When you said before Trump jumped in, and it sounded very lyrical the way you said that, and then I just realized that like there's any number of songs like "Daddy Mac will make you Trump," and just any number of songs with the word "jump" where they can replace the word "Trump," and the possibilities are horrifying.
Silver says at this stage, polls would not yield much of an accurate predictive information, a claim some political observers have cited as reason not to take Trump's poll numbers that seriously. Silver says, people have not given the candidates more than 2 seconds worth of attention. Calm down. It's not a tennis match where you're going back and forth all the time. just keep calm. He cited recent history as proof that candidates in September did not typically hold up. Hillary Clinton was leading the Democratic primary race in September 2007, but she went on to lose to then-Senator Barack Obama.
She's leading now, too.
Yes, and she's probably going to be leading into an indictment over some corruption with the email server thing.
Does it really look like that?
Yeah.
It does?
Yes.
Okay. Well, then, at this point, then you're talking about either the burn or Biden.
Biden's not even officially jumped in.
He's not officially jumped in, but he's really got he's got more than his foot in the water.
There's that Harvard professor that just jumped in the race for the Democratic.
He's going to give up his position once he gets the money out of politics. That's an issue candidate. Issue candidates don't win.
Right, but you know, he might wind up getting some support, pulling votes from people that are realizing, you know, Hillary's a sinking ship.
I don't know who the Republican nominee is going to be.
If Biden becomes the nominee, I will spend every single time I am on this show reminding people about the Rave Act. Every single time.
And what's that? Him not wanting people to dance?
He's responsible for the Rave Act. Yeah, it's it's the act that basically says that if you have a loud music party, that you can be shut down, essentially. It's specifically targeted raves, but it doesn't have to be limited to that. And it's basically, it's something about drug use. It's just essentially to target any loud music event.
Well, the fact is that people don't pay that much attention to issues. They're much more concerned with these negative attack ads when the time comes. When Biden, if Biden gets the nomination, the negative attack ads are going to be full of him groping people's wives and daughters and sisters right there on stages without people caring. The guy's he's the creepiest candidate out there. And
yeah.
I got to say
Uncle McTouchy Fingers.
Yeah, he's not going anywhere. Clinton, Sanders, these guys are all very interesting, but they're not going anywhere. It's the Republican primary is the race to look at this year. I don't know who's going to win, and I'm not saying that they're, many of them I find more dangerous than the Democrats, but it doesn't change the fact that that's where it is.
Silver also predicted that if Trump's support did not erode, that the Republican establishment, which vehemently opposes Trump, could still work overtime to change the rules for the primaries to make it more difficult for Trump. He reminds people that the nomination process is not purely Democratic. It's the party's process to bestow. The fact that the Republican Party establishment hates Donald Trump isn't a very good thing. The party has to give you the nomination. And this is me speaking, not Nate Silver. The Republican Party and the Democratic Party are private institutions, private clubs with private rules. So, it doesn't matter who votes how in the primary. It matters what their rules are at the convention.
You think Trump's going to pull this off? 855-450-3733. Are you a rabid Sanders fan? You think he's going to do it? 855-450-3733. Free Talk Live.
Want gold but also want to stay digital and decentralized on the Bitcoin blockchain? Anthem Vault, providing trusted, world-class vaulting, has your answer with Hayek Gold. Digital, spendable gold inspired by economist and free market philosopher F.A. Hayek. Each Hayek is worth 1 gram of gold and is available right now at AnthemVault.com. Sign up today at AnthemVault.com with promo code FREEDOM to earn 6 months of free storage and 5% off all margins for life. Hayek Gold at AnthemVault.com. Get yours today.
Last Friday, Allison Cohn made her status FBF to a pic of me as a pipsqueak. Awkward. It got 59 likes and 12 comments. Impressive, Allie. Geico also has a comment on your Flashback Friday. Did you know Geico has been saving people money on car insurance for over 75 years? Bet you didn't even know they made cars back then. And if you think your flashback is awkward, you should see our pic. Hashtag blurry. Hashtag over 75 years of savings.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
You pick up the receiver. With your heart racing and sweat dripping from your forehead, you finally muster the courage to dial the number to call into your favorite talk radio show. It rings once, twice, and then...
Hello, it's GCN. What's your name and the state you're calling from?
Surprised you got through, you squeak out...
Jason from Minnesota.
Please hold.
As you patiently wait for your turn, you begin to daydream about being a famous talk radio host and what it would be like to have your own show.
Jason from Minnesota, you're up.
Millions of loyal listeners worldwide waiting to call and talk to you. You.
Caller, are you there?
Cheering crowds surround you, calling out your name.
Jason.
Going once. Twice. Jason. Okay, we gotta move on to the next caller.
You blew it.
Huh? Wait, no!
Interact with the hosts you're listening to right now online at gcnlive.com. Click on the community link. Engage with other listeners. Ask questions. Start debates. Don't agree with the host? Let them know. Be a part of the community at gcnlive.com.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit gcnlive.com today.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. The Senate has blocked efforts to derail President Obama's Iran nuclear deal.
In a victory for the president, opponents of the disapproval resolution were able to stop it in its tracks, despite arguments like this one from Republican Dan Coats of Indiana, who said the U.S. made too many concessions to Iran.
We have seen this before. Peace at any price is not peace.
Democrat Joe Donnelly, also from Indiana, said the Iran nuclear deal is the best possible hope for peace.
This agreement rolls back Iran's nuclear capabilities, shrinks its program, and gives us unprecedented access.
The House is working on a separate bill on the Iran nuclear deal. Linda Kenyon, Capitol Hill.
That former State Department official who set up and maintained Hillary Clinton's private email server pleaded the Fifth Amendment today. House Select Committee on Benghazi Chairman Trey Gowdy says former State Department official Brian Pagliano refused to answer questions posed by the committee.
He has a right to not answer questions that he thinks may incriminate him, and you have a right to glean whatever inference you want from the fact that he has not answered based on the fact it may incriminate him.
Pagliano's lawyers said he will also refuse to testify if served with a subpoena by two Senate committees looking into the email controversy. The Obama administration plans to admit some 10,000 Syrian refugees to the United States. White House Press Secretary Josh Earnest says accepting more Syrian refugees will help, but doing more to care for those still in the Middle East will help more.
The most effective response to this urgent humanitarian situation is for the international community to ramp up our humanitarian efforts in the region and even in Syria. The United States is the largest donor to those efforts.
He also says Americans shouldn't worry that corners will be cut that would allow terrorists to enter the country. On Wall Street, the Dow by 77 points. More on these stories at townhall.com.
Honey, I'm really worried about our retirement funds.
Oh, me too. We lost so much value in the recession and the stock market. I'm worried we won't have enough to retire.
Jim next door told me that he had set up a new kind of IRA with a Gold Silver Group. He said how simple and safe it was. It's a private storage IRA, and we could have real gold and silver in our hands.
Really? You mean we can actually see it and touch it?
Absolutely. Jim said we could have all the benefits of an IRA to help build our retirement income. Bottom line, we would own a real tangible asset, and we would have the security of knowing we're protected no matter what the economy does. What do you think?
I think we need to find out how to get our own private storage IRA. We need to call the Gold Silver Group right now.
Are you ready to protect your future? Call 800-296-7609 now to find out how easy and safe it is to set up a private storage IRA with Gold Silver Group and find out how you can qualify for up to $700 in free silver. All transactions are privately delivered and fully insured. Please call us now. 800-296-7609. 800-296-7609.
Department of Public Safety spokesman Tim Case in Arizona says authorities are investigating yet another shooting in the Phoenix area, this time a bullet hole found in the cargo area of a commercial truck this morning.
8:45 this morning, occurred on westbound I-10. Semi-truck heard a noise, pulled over here, called us. He has a little dent in the truck. It's from a projectile flying through and hitting it. We don't know what it is yet.
Arizona Department of Public Safety spokesman Bart Graves says the shootings are their top priority now.
We are putting all available resources from our department into this investigation. We have unmarked and marked police vehicles on the roadway. We have undercover as well as uniformed officers working.
DPS previously listed 10 other incidents involving vehicles on freeways getting hit with gunfire or other projectiles in the last 2 weeks. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. a memorial and visitors center honoring the victims of United Airlines Flight 93, which was hijacked and crashed as part of the September 11, 2001 terror attacks, opened today in Pennsylvania. Interior Secretary Sally Jewell says she was very moved by the exhibits in the Flight 93 National Memorial Visitors Center.
The book that Todd Beamer was reading before the flight. An award that Margaret Britton received for her exemplary work in the U.S. Census Bureau. A uniform patch from Leroy Homer's U.S. Air Force flight suit.
The aircraft, which officials believe the hijackers intended to crash into the U.S. Capitol, was overtaken by passengers and crashed in a field in western Pennsylvania at the site of the new memorial. 40 passengers and crew members, as well as the four Islamic terrorists, died in the crash. That memorial is located in Shanksville, Pennsylvania. More on these stories at townhall.com.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey System. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Talk Live. So we were in the end of last hour, gotten into the primary elections that are coming up here and who can win and who can lose. And Johnson, you brought in a question from Tom Woods, which I think is really good.
Yeah.
So now, before we get into it, I got to say Bernie Sanders is my favorite on the Democratic side. Not because of his stance, which is highly socialist, but because he seems just like a much more authentic person. You can believe him more than you can sort of most of the people that have been running for office, frankly, throughout the years. I think that much of the reason there's excitement behind Bernie Sanders right now is just because people trust him because he's been relatively consistent in his votes for what he believes in. So what's the question, Johnson?
I guess. I don't know. These people, the politicians are all liars. And, you know, I don't care whether or not you trust them. You know, people thought that they could trust Obama, too. And he turned out to be a gigantic liar. So, yeah. But
Obama didn't have the voting record behind him that Sanders does.
Okay. Well, crazy is as crazy does. And Tom Woods brings up a great question to people who support this lunatic, And I'll quote, "My question to Bernie Sanders supporters, when someone in Bangladesh observes your lifestyle, it seems as incredible to them as that of the 1% seems to you."
And the 1%, and by the way, it's not even the 1%, it's the 0.01%.
Yeah. Right, right.
But the 0.01%'s lifestyle does seem incredible to me. I would love to be able to jump on a jet and go any old place I wanted to for a couple of days or whatever and have a big boat and these kind of things. These people have some amazing lifestyles compared to me, who's, I get good food and I don't have to worry about too much. I've got a shower, I've got a roof over my head, I've got the basics of life, and I'm delighted about that. But I get that there's a difference between sort of my lifestyle and that from somebody from, say, Bangladesh.
Mark, the people that you're talking about, the uber rich, those are the type of people that would wind up being on Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous with Robin Leach.
Yeah, that's good stuff.
Something wishes and caviar dreams. What was it? Cocaine wishes and caviar dreams?
I don't
think
it's cocaine.
Champagne.
Yeah, champagne, cocaine, close enough.
Well, so to reiterate here, he says, when someone in Bangladesh observes your lifestyle, it seems as incredible to them as that of the 1% seems to you. Why are they not entitled to help themselves to your things, the way that you consider yourself morally entitled to help yourself to the goods of the American rich? In your answer, avoid moral irrelevancies like national borders. I mean, can we tolerate inequality just because it's cross-border? And extra credit, take a picture of yourself divesting yourself of most of your goods in the name of global equality.
I think that that's a pretty strong argument. The national borders are completely arbitrary. Now, obviously, Sanders would be running for the U.S. presidency, not for the world presidency, but they are completely arbitrary. So why not just take the wealth of the United States
sure.
and pass it out to all these other countries?
And you know what? I think a lunatic like Sanders would absolutely love to do something like that.
We'll see. Let's go to...
I don't know. He wants to build a wall.
Sure, but he'll build a wall to keep everyone in while sending all the money out of the country so that we're a third world country like every, you know, other, like...
He wants to build a wall?
I know he doesn't want immigrants. Like, he's totally anti-immigrant.
Well, he doesn't like the idea of anything moving across borders, let alone labor, probably. Let's go to Andy calling in from Texas. Andy, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, how you guys doing?
All's well.
Hey, well, you know, as far as these presidential candidates go, you already know it's Jeb Bush and Hillary Clinton. You already know it. They're establishment candidates. It doesn't matter what they do now. It doesn't matter what they do in the near future. They
wasn't
got plenty of time to...
Wasn't it supposed to be Clinton in 08, too?
Yeah, well, Obama came in, and he happened to be... They both went to the Bilderberg group, so...
they drank the blood of the sacrifice at the Bohemian Grove.
Exactly, exactly. Yeah, they sacrificed that child at the base of that wooden clown or whatever.
They worshiped their... sacrificed their souls in front of the Al Moloch, the statue.
Exactly. See, now you see what I'm saying here.
No, I don't.
Think about it. You got two establishment candidates in there.
Well, I'll agree with you that it's hard to beat establishment candidates. However, that's just because people say it's hard to beat establishment candidates. That's just like people tend to vote for the person that they think that can win. So people will not vote for, you know, Sanders because they say, well, he can't win, so I'll just put my vote behind Hillary Clinton. They don't understand math.
Well, Sanders is actually leading in New Hampshire, Iowa, and South Carolina right now.
And that's fantastic. Ron Paul was leading in a lot of different areas, too, but they pushed him under the table.
Where was he leading? He won polls.
He won Iowa, but they said that Wetzel Dinkel, who's running for president, he won it, too. So, I mean...
There were two conflicting reports on that, the mainstream report was that he lost.
Right. Iowa is a caucus state, not a primary. So what happened in Iowa was, yes, Ron Paul should have won the Iowa caucus, but the candidate that was second and the candidate that was third wound up making a deal to where... Basically, the delegates for candidate number three went to candidate number two. That pushed candidate number two into first spot in front of Ron Paul.
It was something that otherwise would have never happened if they weren't trying to marginalize.
The establishment media, they pick who they want to progress. And it's usually the person who gets the most money.
Wait a second, is it the media? Or is it the Bilderberg
group?
I'm not sure which is
it. It's the media, which is bought and paid for by the globalists.
What is it?
I think the Bilderberg group runs the media because
which ones
the
media
heads are at the Bilderberg group.
All of the media, they're bought and paid for by these corporate globalists.
So here's what I don't understand, Andy. I do not believe this theory that you're purporting. And here's the reason.
Okay.
I have never been offered one penny to change my opinion. No one has ever approached me and said, you know, Mark, you look like the wishy-washiest, money-grubbinest of the hosts on Free Talk Live. I tell you what, for 10 grand a year, 10 grand a year. So imagine what you could buy with 10 grand a year, Mark. For 10 grand a year, you, every once in a while, you pop in with a few things that we email you, and everything's cool. No one has ever said anything like that to me. And I can't,
okay.
If the media was this controlled, if the Bilderberg group was so, thoroughly in charge of things, why wouldn't they just rub out somebody like Alex Jones? I mean, how expensive is it to send out a hitman? I hear on the news,
it's like
$10,000 or $20,000.
If you kill Alex Jones, then that just proves that the Bilderbergs exist.
It doesn't do anything like that. Make it an accident.
Now the man's talking back in the background there.
That's bull crap, Andy.
He makes him a martyr.
They killed people following him. They killed that one reporter guy, supposedly, in Los Angeles.
From the Rolling Stones.
Wait a second. The guy that was in the automobile accident.
The Rolling Stone guy.
Whatever his name is, they can just make it look like an accident. I mean, or surely these incredibly wealthy people have some little drug they can slip into a drink that causes somebody to have an aneurysm. No one's going to call Alex Jones's aneurysm anything but natural causes.
I'm surprised he's not had an aneurysm on the air from screaming and yelling so much about having all the government documents.
He went to a bar down from his house where he normally goes to have a drink, and the guy died on the way home after having a couple glasses of wine, and he was perfectly healthy, and it was right after he spoke at the RNC. They can do anything. You're absolutely right. And you know, in some respects, I think Alex Jones might be some sort of operative. I don't know, because they let him live. He talks a bunch of stuff that you can go validate. Same thing. How come are you still alive?
Oh, jeez.
How come they're letting you live?
Andy, are you seriously coming? You think that the Bilderberg Group is letting you come on my show? And by the way, you came on without anybody ahead of you and call me a gatekeeper for the Bilderberg Group? And then...
Oh, hell no. I didn't call you that at all.
Okay.
Not at all, dude.
Okay. I thought that's what you were saying. Because, I mean,
hell no.
I just don't think the media is that controlled.
I've called you several times now. I'll tell you straight up. I think you guys are awesome. I like the topics you bring up. This is just a fantastic show, and I like to get involved in it. And it's called Free Talk Live, so I Free Talk Live.
If you could choose any school in the country to earn your college degree and be on your way to a better life, would you choose one the Wall Street Journal recognizes as producing some of the best qualified graduates? Or one the Princeton Review ranks as a leader in undergraduate education? Or maybe one the U.S. News & World Report names among the most innovative schools in the country? Now, you don't have to choose. At Arizona State University, we want to help you learn to thrive in life. At ASU Online, we offer over 100 graduate and undergraduate programs on your time and schedule. You receive the exact same curriculum, degree, and prestigious faculty as the on-campus students, and we're universally recognized as one of the innovators in online learning technologies. For information, call 1-800-595-9736. U.S. News & World Report ranked ASU in the top 10 best places to earn an online degree. So learn to thrive with ASU Online. Call today at 1-800-595-9736. That's 1-800-595-9736.
Gold. It's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-223. For the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified. For thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC.com.
Are you tired of commuting to a job that makes someone else rich, working harder than ever, but getting nowhere? Do you hate spending hundreds of dollars every week on daycare, having someone else raise your children? With our opportunities, you can start earning money as soon as next week. you get to be the boss, work from home, and live a happier life. At Be the Boss Network, you'll find hundreds of work-from-home opportunities that you can literally start today and be earning money as soon as next week. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss. Get out of the rat race. Work from home. Go to freedom106.com right now and change your life today. That's freedom, the number 106.com. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You be the boss. Go to freedom106.com.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618. Blockitpocket.com. Enhancing health and privacy.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Yeah! Come on! Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-453. You can call in, talk about whatever you want to talk about. We've been talking about the primary election, Trump, and all these things that are going down right now. And people do want to talk about that stuff.
Monica Lewinsky?
I can tell you something that's far more relevant to you. I don't know what that has to do. Oh, I got you.
Yeah.
Very clever. Far more relevant to your life is saveatpurse.com. Because at saveatpurse.com, you can get just about everything you need to live your life at a 25% discount. Call it 15 to 30% discount. But the trick is you have to use Bitcoin. Now, what it is it works through Amazon. And you know Amazon has just about everything you need to live. And you take a discount by making sort of offers and deals with people around the world who have an Amazon credit.
I buy all my air from Amazon.
Well, at this point, air is still free. saveatpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com. Go get signed up there. Get yourself some Bitcoin. You can get Bitcoin. I'll tell you how to get some Bitcoin at a better price here shortly. But they do have it at saveatpurse.com. Let's go to Mark calling in from Cincinnati. Mark, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, y'all. How you doing?
All's well. What's on your mind?
Thanks for taking my call. I was just thinking about like Trump and how much I've seen him in the media and how absurd it is and how much his ascendancy really, to my mind, speaks to the absolute worst that conservatism is. You know, xenophobic, warmongering, anti-intellectual invertebrates, hateful. I mean,
tell us what you really think.
He nabbed that glorious David Duke endorsement, which everybody wants.
Right. I got to say, if you're going for the same candidate that David Duke endorses, that's rough.
Yeah, I mean, it's brutal. But, I mean, that's honestly, you want to strip conservatism down to its bare elements. I mean, that's kind of what it is nowadays. I mean, we're well past the William F. Buckley types.
I don't know that
you know, the American Conservative Magazine is not the standard for conservatism anymore. It just isn't. You know?
No, it's American Conservative Magazine is a libertarian magazine. But, mm-hmm. You know, what I think conservative means, we just talked about it on the air the other night here, is it means different things to different people. And I think ultimately what it means, here's what my definition of conservatism is. I have years of sort of looking at it and studying it, is it's just fear of change. Ultimately, it's fear of things being different than they are. And maybe you will hearken back to some time when they were better. It seems like both the Democrats and the Republicans look at the 50s and say, things were better in the 50s, probably because they watched Happy Days when they were younger. And it looked really
and Leave
great.
It to Beaver.
Yeah, Leave It to Beaver was nice, too. My Three Sons. Those are good shows.
Andy Griffith Show.
So I kind of think that the conservatives, yes, there's certainly the social conservatives. They get wrapped up in lots of issues. They're losers, and they don't make Republicans look very good, but ultimately, there's people that vote Republican that just want to lower taxes, too.
Well, I think that's just it. And I think that when you talk about the sort of like myth of Republicans wanting a little, you know, smaller government, of course, that's an absurdity. And we all know that it is. But, you know, I saw your post on Facebook tonight, and that was actually why I called in, because the post mentioned that whomever it was had said that Trump's not going to get the nomination. There's no way he's getting the nomination. I mean, if you spent $100 million-plus on Bush, I mean, it's pretty obvious that the establishment has already chosen their candidate, which is the presumptive candidate's Bush. Man, I can't imagine that the establishment would in any sense allow Trump to be the nominee. Do you? I mean, I
tend to think that that would be difficult for him to get through the Republican primary, but I also hear people that say things like, well, Perot certainly wasn't picked by the establishment. He did significantly better, and Trump has done a far better job of sort of articulating his position and, you know, self-promoting himself, that he might be a player. I don't know the answer as to whether or not Trump could win in a general. It seems unlikely he could win in a primary, but the race isn't over at that point either.
Well, one thing that's interesting is right now there are 18 major candidates for the Republican primary thing.
That is such a ridiculous number.
And then there's a bunch of other ones that the media is not even talking about that have, you know, like created committees and are probably just going to be on, you know, like one or two ballots. But by the time you get, you know, through, say, 15 of the primaries, people are going to be dropping off. You're not going to have more than maybe 10 or 11 people on some of the primaries. Like the first 15 primaries are going to have at least 18 candidates. And we know that because the deadline for filing for these primaries is before the very first primary happens. So somebody could say, like, I'm not running anymore after New Hampshire, but they're still going to be on like the next 14 primary ballots. So people are going to start dropping out. The field's going to winnow away a little bit. And then you're going to see the people that, you know, right now aren't necessarily leaning towards Trump or Carson or Fiorina. You'll see where they start throwing their support after their, you know, number one candidate drops out of the race.
Yeah, I think you're absolutely correct in that assessment. You know, I mean,
Mark, do you think you'll vote? Will you vote in the Democratic or the Republican primary?
No, I'm never voting. I'm an anarchist.
Yeah, well, hold on. These are not self-exclusive titles. One can,
I'm sorry, I don't mean to be too abrupt, but
one can believe that the government is an illegitimate ruler and still understand that there's going to be a president in 2016, and you know, vote in self-defense, right?
Sure, but I also think voting's an immoral stance. I think it's an immoral action because I'm legitimizing a system that I think is just inherently immoral.
If you go out and target practice with a gun, you don't legitimize murder.
I know. This argument's always been crazy.
Not necessarily a person if I'm shooting target practice. If I'm voting,
let me ask you a question.
I'm legitimizing a system that I find to be abhorrent because it's legitimizing coercion.
I don't think it's legitimizing it at all. Have you ever been disappointed, thoroughly disappointed and burned out by an election?
No, I have low expectations.
All right, I've got a better question. I want to ask you, if six big burly guys come and they tell you, we're going to hold you down and rape you, boy. And they've voted with their six, but you say, no, don't. Have you legitimized the rape?
First of all, I should say that I think that's more or less an absurd situation that you're...
It's a moral equivalency
your
test.
Argument is.
You're expressing your opinion. They outnumber you.
Dude, I'll bite. All right, fine.
Yeah. I said this on a previous show, so I've actually... This is like a real-life example.
My protests are meaningless at that point because they're not listening to my protest, okay? So just me stating that I don't want to get raped by six burly dudes, as you put it, does not change the situation.
It's statistically insignificant.
What if you find out, though, that three of them have a conscience? I mean, come on.
Okay. Daryl's asking me to hold you over.
I want to hold you over.
I want the answer to this question when we come back.
855-450-3733. Let's beat up on the guy who calls himself an anarchist. 855-450-FREE.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral. Don't pick on the IRS alone. I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
Does being over 40 make you feel like half the man you used to be? You feel more tired, out of shape, not in the mood like you used to be? Thanks to an exclusive formula, you can help boost testosterone levels safely and naturally. Introducing Ageless Male, a life-changing supplement for men tested to help increase testosterone levels.
You'll notice a boost in your energy levels. Workouts work, sex life improves. It's like a light switch goes on.
Try Ageless Male risk-free if you would like to experience what taking Ageless Male can feel like. Support for healthy, normal testosterone levels, healthy energy, and increased performance, and more romance when you want it.
Call 1-800-327-4821. That's 1-800-327-4821. 800-327-4821. 800-327-4821. That's 1-800-327-4821.
Just recently, we've witnessed some of the most catastrophic disasters in history. Be sure to prepare yourself with great-tasting, high-quality, GMO-free food that has a 25-year shelf life. Of course, we're talking about the foods from SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. And don't forget, the human body needs up to 3 quarts of water every day to remain healthy and hydrated. So check out our water bricks at SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. Go to SurvivalFoodAlliance.com or call 877-223-1776.
Most of us already know that taking a fish oil supplement to boost omega-3s is a good idea. But did you know that about 60% of Americans are actually deficient in omega-3s? Did you know that most fish oil products contain only about 25% omega-3s and the remaining 75% is undesirable fish fat? Heck, did you know that more than 90% of fish oil supplements sold in the USA are not even made here? If you want to boost your omega-3s using the finest American-made fish oil, check out Nutrigold Fish Oil Supplements on www.fishoil.best. Nutrigold fish oils are independently 5-star certified and guaranteed to be exceptionally pure. That means no more fish burps. Best of all, just one Nutrigold fish oil capsule contains more omega-3s than 4 standard fish oil capsules. Go to www.fishoil.best or call 888-920-1497 and use promo code BESTFISHOIL to get a free 1-month supply. That's www.fishoil.best or call 888-920-1497.
So I found out the other day that at guns80.com, a lot of people don't get the Ghost AR-15 rifle kits because they're afraid that they won't be able to do the machining work required to drill out and make ready the lower. Well, listen, guys, gals, I am not that good of a machinist, I promise you. But I was able to take a drill press with an XY table and knock this out in about 45 minutes, and in all honesty, mine looks really good. Go get yours, don't be afraid, it's easy. Guns80.com, go to guns80.com now.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in and talk about whatever you want. Apparently, we've drug up somebody who believes voting is immoral, and you guys want to ask him some questions. Yeah, so.
I do want to ask some questions.
I got to say, I like this game as much as anybody, so we'll and he's being a good sport. That's Mark from
I should have apologized to people and said, trigger warning before I ask my question.
I told everybody I was going to tell you how to get some Bitcoin. The best way to do it is go through ExpressCoin.com. They've got the lowest rates. All you need to do is send them a check or a money order. They're fast, safe, easy, inexpensive. You can get Bitcoins, Litecoin, Dogecoin, Dashcoin, a variety of other cryptocurrencies over there at ExpressCoin.com, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada. That's cool. You just use coupon code FTL. You can get up to $40 worth of whatever cryptocurrency you want for no fee at all if you use coupon code FTL at ExpressCoin.com. Back to Mark in Cincinnati. So Mark's tripped over, set off two trigger warnings here at Free Talk Live. He's both called himself an anarchist, which always gets me whipped up. And then he's said that he believes that voting perpetuates the system. Is that correct, Mark?
Well, I think it legitimizes the system. To vote is to say that you gave your implicit consent that the system is legitimate. And I should also state that the situation you gave me is not necessarily morally coordinate with voting, because the situation you gave me was that if I'm going to be raped again by, like,
trigger warning,
as you described it, eight burly dudes.
Sure. Now it's up to eight, but okay.
He initially said six, but you found two more.
These odds are going to the odds ever be in your favor.
Well, football season is kicking off this weekend. The Bengals are in town, so it's very likely that there's eight
basically
burly dudes in Cincinnati that,
like, that
would be
I'm
willing
not given
to
the
rape Mark.
I'm saying that they're going. I give them the option that they have insisted they want to rape me. It's not like me saying, okay, and like my protests don't necessarily mean that they can't violate me in another way.
Clearly you shouldn't have been dressed like that.
But the two-party system that we're talking about, the option, the difference between the two is, like, infinitesimal. So if I only have the option of either being raped or being forced to do other things in this horrendous sexual situation that you have put me in, like, I mean, I don't even understand what that argument, I don't understand how the two are coordinated.
Okay, Mark, I will give you a real-life example that could be a real possibility there in Cincinnati. Let's say that there's an election coming up in another month and a half, as there is here in New Hampshire, and there's a ballot question that says, do you want your taxes to go up by 1%? Would you be willing to vote no on raising taxes? Because that would be an actual vote in self-defense. Or would you believe
again,
that voting no legitimizes them asking you the question?
I would not. Because I don't believe in a system that I don't believe. I don't want to support a system that I believe is illegitimate.
What do you mean support?
Well, here. You can take a position of complete utilitarianism in life, and that's fine. That's fine for other people. That's not fine with me. I take a position of being, for me.
I take a moral position too.
So let me
wait,
hold on.
I'm sorry. I'm not trying to say that you're immoral for voting necessarily. I'm saying that it's not a right for me.
Well, you could whatever's right for you. If you find voting yucky, that's fine. But when you claim that it perpetuates the system, I have a rebuttal to that, and I think it's very important.
Okay,
when you
please,
look at the vast majority of elections that have occurred in the United States and around the world, some countries are accepted, but let's just use the United States. It's a little easier. When you look at the vast majority of elections in the United States, fewer than 50% of the population has voted. So therefore, the non-voter people have won the vast majority of the elections. However, in that time frame, the government has gotten bigger and more intrusive. I can look at the results of this and say that not voting then must mean that the government gets bigger and more intrusive. And now, I don't actually believe that, because I think that's a ludicrous stance, but I think it is no difference than your stance that I perpetuate the system.
But do you also at the same time think that if everybody decided they were going to vote, and in the very narrow paradigm that they're allowed to make a decision, that things would change for the better? Do you think that we have a freer society if everybody voted for Bush or Clinton?
I think that the average person shouldn't be allowed
to vote. Because necessarily, isn't that the argument that you're making?
The problem is that stupid people vote.
Mark, let me speak. Good God. Okay, so, you know, onto this moral equivalency of, you know, comparing rape to voting, and especially in regards to taxes, right? I know these things aren't really morally equivalent here because it's, you know, one is much more horrific than the other. However, in both situations, something's being taken from you. Now, you're saying that voting is legitimizing the system. I think I'm just making the argument here. I don't think that that's any more true than telling rapists, don't rape me, because that's what voting essentially is. You're saying, I don't want this. I don't want this to happen. Now, legitimizing the system is paying taxes. That's legitimizing the system in the same way that if you were in a rape situation, pulling down your pants to allow them easier access would be like, is what basically what paying taxes is. It's bending over and allowing easier access to, you know, to the system to take advantage of you. I mean, that's the moral equivalency of these two different, you know, this crazy analogy that I've given here. But
if we're talking about understanding, though, is it's if I don't pay taxes, I go to prison.
Right. Like,
right. So okay. Congratulations on taking the low road, sir. Yeah. You're like, I'm not going to be involved in your system when it's easy.
Right.
Well, I mean, I'm not claiming to be Gandhi necessarily, but I am saying that there are certain things that I can do that. See,
not
that's the
voting
thing too,
isn't a solution to anything.
Basically, no, here's what you're doing.
Here, essentially, that I have to take the nth degree position, that I have to completely delegitimize myself from taking part in anything that happens in society, when the fact of the matter is, as I think you guys both know, and I think most of your colleagues probably know, that they monopolize the system. What, am I not going to drive on a public road because I'm opposed to the fact that it's funded through coercion? That's an absurdity.
The way I view what you're doing...
absurdity. So if I don't vote, that's one thing. If I don't pay taxes, I spend my life in prison. And honestly, I don't really think that it's my responsibility to live my life like an act of protest.
Sure. Well,
but there
I agree
are certain
with,
things
I agree
yes,
with you
I'm
on
not
this,
do
Mark.
That are easy to do, and that's fair.
I agree with you on that. But I would claim to you that not voting isn't an act of anything.
Right.
It is a mathematically insignificant act, just like voting.
Essentially, the moral comparison.
Just like voting is. You're right. No, it is. It is. But so, I mean,
the moral comparison here.
I don't know what you
Mark,
guys are asking of.
But
moral,
this Mark, is important. Let me wrap this up. The fact is that there is. You can't be have something to be significant and insignificant at the same time. Go ahead, Johnson.
So, I mean, the way I view what you're doing here is essentially you're doing exactly what I said is in this situation, like with the taxes and whatnot. Essentially, you're being raped, allowing it to happen, and what you've chosen to do is not say anything about it. That's all that this is in terms of the
really?
Analogy.
Because
yeah,
the only option
really.
That I have of being raped is to not get raped, but maybe not take it in the ass, but take it in the mouth, because essentially that's what voting is. It's like saying, hey, I'm not going to vote for a said candidate.
No, because you can always say no. You can always say, you can write in, you can have, there are other options. You don't have to, it's and it's not legitimized the system to say, no, I don't want this. I've gone and voted, I wrote in Dr. Mary Ruart a couple of times because none of the candidates were good options. You don't always have to say, like they can say to you, we're going to rape you, boy, and it's going to be this way or that away. You can say no. Like you don't have to go, oh, let me agree with the options you're presenting.
But see, I think the fact of the matter is that I don't think societal change is kind of those with a high time preference. In other words, if you actually want to see society change, the electoral process is the absolute worst way for that to happen.
I think on a national level, but if you move for the Free State Project, you'll find that you have the opportunity to vote for people that call themselves voluntarists, libertarians, and even some people that use the term anarchist. Mark?
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm just saying that, if you're in Cincinnati, I don't think you're ever going to get a good choice.
Yeah, and I should also state for the record that I don't necessarily feel that people should subtract themselves from the political process altogether. I mean, but that's what I've chosen to do. But, yeah. I mean, I don't think that, you know, it's not the best option for me. I don't think it's
every once in a while you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it.
Sure.
You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things.
Find it.
Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com.
It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Okay, open your mouth and say ah. When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor recommended Say Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue, and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahahnow.com. Sayahnow.com. The new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
Now you know the smart way to buy emergency food storage is calories per dollar. Ready Supply Foods sells you 50% more food for your money. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. You need 2,000 calories per day under ideal conditions. Most 30-day kits don't have enough calories to sustain you for more than a week. They just don't have enough nutrition to do the job. See the comparisons for yourself at ReadySupplyFoods.com. We are the new leader in value and quality. Go to ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
Pretty small sample size for it to actually match.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Sciatica, lower back pain, hip pain, poor posture. If you suffer from any of these problems, get ready to relax. Introducing an amazing product that's been in the market for over 25 years, the Sacro Wedgie. It was invented by a football coach using a common sense osteopath technique. He created this device to help his athletes by isolating and supporting the sacrum, which is the keystone of our anatomy. This wedge-shaped bone is in the center of our hips, where a lot of pain starts. Simply relax 20 minutes daily on the amazingly simple Sacro Wedgie. Gravity do the work, helping muscles rebalance and start releasing nerves. Sit in the Sacro Wedgie at the computer or while traveling to help correct posture to finally help relieve those stubborn aches and pains for only $33.95. It's made in the USA, so click the family-owned website at sacrowedgie.com, spelled S-A-C-R-O-W-E-D-G-Y.com, or call 1-800-737-9295. That's 1-800-737-9295. Relax your back pain away with the Sacro Wedgie.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order, Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. If you support the ideas of liberty, well, I'm going to tell you, there's only one radio program out there that believes wholly in the ideas of liberty and is on more than 150 radio stations across the country. If you want us to spread those ideas farther and wider than we currently do, the best way to do that is to get involved in the AMP program. You go to amp.freetalklive.com, sign up for the AMP program. It costs you $5 a month. There's some perks, including the very exciting Amplifier group on Facebook, which is very busy, and I think next week I'm supposed to be posting some pictures of me riding a couple of my pigs in that group. So I'm trying to get people who are already amplifiers to just get part of the group because I want it to be a little bigger. But if you happen to sign up for the Amplifier program by then, you will be also be able to.
And this may be the only way to get that kind of content, right? Because now Ian's talking about, or I don't know if he already went ahead with, retiring the forums.
The BBS.
Oh, no.
At bbs.freetalklive.com. I believe it's in stasis. You can look at it, but it doesn't, you can't
okay,
post
so
it.
He has already gone ahead and locked it down then.
I think
yes. That happened like 2 hours after he asked the question of should I retire.
That's how
It was as if a million Alex Libmans cried out in horror.
Poor
and
Alex.
Then was suddenly silenced.
Let's go to the phones. Got Nathan on Skype. Nathan, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
So does that mean that no one's going to post the new Free Talk Live bumpers to the BBS for me to look up now?
That's true.
Oh, that's very sad.
They're
so,
Rebel Inc. if you like the bumpers.
I've listened to about 10 Rebel Inc. songs and still haven't found it, but I'll keep trying. So there was this movie that I heard about called No Escape. Have any of you seen it?
Never
Not
heard
the
of
new
it.
One, but I've seen the old one with Ray Liotta.
Okay, so a quick summary. It's an action film. It was released a few weeks ago. It's about this American engineer who goes to an unnamed Asian country when a revolution happens. And so then action antics ensue as he has to escape this country and escape with his family. I was more interested.
Okay.
Indeed. So what I was interested, though, in is the review that I watched on YouTube by some basically some liberal people. They're pretty leftist. And I noticed something interesting about the way they talked about it. One of them said, well, I like this movie, but since it's racist, I'm cutting my score in half. And the other guy, the one who actually writes for newspapers and seems to be like a knowledgeable film critic kind of guy, he actually said, this is a good action movie in terms of its technical, the technical aspects of it, like the camera work and the scenes that keeps the movie moving along. You know, he's throwing his daughter over the roof to save her and this and that. And it keeps good pacing, but it's evil. So I'm giving this a 3 out of 10. And so I wanted to get your guys' reaction to this. Do you think A, that a movie is inherently racist if the main character is white and everyone else is Asian, and B, why or why not?
What's the question?
Is a movie racist?
And is that bad?
Yeah, if the protagonist of the movie is white when it's a movie based around Asian culture starring everyone else is Asian.
I mean, to put this in perspective, the Asian characters who were trying to kill them have no lines. That you could replace them with monsters or zombies and the movie would still be the same.
I don't think that's racist any more than, I mean, frankly, they use zombies and monsters and robots and aliens as stand-ins for people all the time. It's just trying to show the other. So in this case, if they're showing the other as being, some guy who somehow got himself whipped up into the some kind of Asian underground mobster thing or whatever, as long as somebody can make a movie about an Asian, Jackie Chan coming here and getting involved with the Italian mafia and being chased around by white guys, I don't find that to be racist either.
I think that all market research is racist because you're trying to, you're trying to cater to a profit motive, which means that you're going to cater to a majority. So clearly you're never going to be catering to minorities. Therefore, you're a racist. And everything based on market research is racist. And therefore inherently evil, and so we can't support anything popular because I supported everything that was not popular before it was cool to do stuff.
Hold
because
on,
I'm the
hold
ultimate
on.
Hipster.
Defense Exhibit A, Friday. Defense Exhibit B, Straight Outta Compton. I rest my case.
What are you talking about?
Friday and Straight Outta Compton were not marketed and aimed at the majority. They were marketed to a minority, so therefore your
So what you're saying is that those movies were not written based on market research then, right?
You said every movie is
No, based I said everything on... based on market research.
No. I didn't
Not
fully
everything
pay attention.
Is done for market research. Some things are done for creative integrity.
If you argue with Daryl, you always lose.
You always lose.
Nathan.
Well, Daryl, before I follow
right.
up,
just wasted your time.
What do you think, Daryl? Is it racist?
And I don't know. Not? I've not even heard of the movie until you called.
Well,
so,
here's the proposition, though. A white guy goes to an Asian country. He's fighting bad guys who are Asians, and they don't get much for lines and that sort of thing. So good guy, white guy, bad guy, Asians. Is that racist?
I would have to know more about the plot to know, like, are the Asian people being denigrated simply because they're Asian?
Hold on, let me ask this question.
If the main character was black, would it be a different movie? If the main character was also Asian, would it be a completely different movie?
Well, I don't think so, and this is what I thought.
Okay, then it's not racist. Like, the ethnicity of the main character is completely irrelevant to the point of the movie, then no, it's not racist. If the ethnicity of the main character is, you know, like, this is a plot point because he's yelling racial epithets at everybody he sees, then okay, it would be racist.
I want to bring the show full circle. I want to ask, like, this is like South Park. If Trump builds a border on the Mexican border, you know, Vince, if he builds a wall on the Mexican border, will Mongolians suddenly show up to tear it down?
Stupid Mongolians.
They're Mongolians.
I have no clue what you're talking about.
Yeah. There's several episodes of South Park where
it's a good South Park reference.
He tries
there.
To build the Great Wall of China with the guy who runs the Chinese restaurant in South Park, and every single time he does, within a minute, just a horde of Mongolians show up to tear down the Great Wall that he's attempting to build.
I hope some Mongolians show up to Keene because I love Mongolian barbecue.
Well, it's even more ironic because the guy turns out to be white in a different episode.
Mongolian barbecue is you. Let's not forget that Genghis Khan and his hordes killed far, far more than Hitler ever did. You know, these things were so...
Well, you're not going to hear the leftist media talk about that. And that's what really kind of, hit me the most is that, I mean, these are obviously very leftist people that are reviewing this movie and this clip that I watched, and I could just see on their faces, like, oh my God, this movie, it's...
I wonder how they'd rate the Netflix show Marco Polo, which also stars a white person and is surrounded by Asians.
Yes, he is. I just don't understand. If Jackie Chan or Jet Li, he's better because he doesn't have his grade of command of the English language. If he comes here and he fights a bunch of American mobsters, that wouldn't be considered racist at all. That would just be the plot line of a story. But, you know, that I'm sure they're not going to boycott that movie or give it a lower rating. Jet Li's awesome.
No, exactly. That's the point, is that it's because it's a white person. And of course, it's his white family that he's trying to save from the Asian hordes that are trying to come after him.
Is it mobsters or what are they exactly?
Well, they're revolutionaries because apparently he belongs to this American corporation that's taking over this country's resources. They're like they added like this little line where he talks about, oh, I actually came here to exploit the resources. That's why they're all trying to kill me. But it doesn't really matter. I mean, that's the only, you know, shawl of an explanation we get for all of the violence and action. Like I said, they could just as well be zombies. It just floored me just how, like, how brazen, like, how open they were with their bias, and they were just sort of like, yeah, it's white, so it's racist, you know, just, if only this movie could have been about, you know, a brown guy fighting off white. I mean, they didn't say that, but that was the implication.
If it had been Denzel Washington doing this instead, it wouldn't have been a problem, right?
That was the strong impression that I got. Yeah,
that's my guy, by the way, Denzel Washington. I think he is one of the greatest actors in Hollywood, and wish he got better, a better play. He seems to get short shrift, and he always gets kind of the surly guy role. It seems like he made his chops in Glory on the surly guy role. I've got a few others I like too, but Denzel.
Has he done the cop movies where it's the good cop and the bad cop, or the white cop and the black cop, or
he's
whatever?
He's done all that, but he's always the bad cop.
Okay.
I liked him in Virtuosity. He was the good cop.
What was that?
Virtuosity. It was him and Russell Crowe in the 90s, where he's fighting off an amalgamation of many multi-serial killers who are actually now nanotech body.
I have no idea what you're talking
about. It's a very old movie. It's very good. Virtuosity.
And anyway, thanks for the call, Nathan. Appreciate it.
By good, I mean terrible, but awesome.
Check us out in the meantime at facebook.freetalklive.com. You want to see those pictures of me riding a pig? Well, amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA?
Stop searching. With Easy DNS, you found a keeper. Easy DNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. Easy DNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for